vacation. I am going to! Go ahead and get the show started, alright? So real quick, I want to explain what we're doing. We're going to be hanging out with Saruei, Porcelain Maid, and Sinder, who is not Ellie. And we're going to go ahead and try to lie to each other for fun and see how it goes. It's basically going to be two truths and a lie on steroids, okay? So we're going to go ahead and take like a 5-minute break while I call them. I get set up. I get everyone good to go, okay? Does that make sense? Are we good, chat? It's going to be a quick 5-minute break. Alright, yeah, I kind of like put a decent amount of work into it, so hopefully you guys enjoy it, but yeah, that's the play. Alright, okay, I will go ahead and take my piece for 5 minutos, alright, let me come over here, well, bam, alright, I'll be right back, here, shaw, fishing, where is it, here, okay, BRB!
Get the rag. We have to clean it up.
All right. Let me finish setting up real quick. Let me see. I'm gonna get my application. Swap avatar.
Aye, Captain.
So I have a question. Just between you and me, guys. Like, we're muted right now. What is like your
wait, thing that you would say?
Okay.
Hold on.
Okay.
Jesus.
All right.
Hold on, chat. Wait. You guys aren't allowed to hear this.
Yeah. All right. Okay. You're muted, right?
Now they can't hear you.
Okay, cool. So, like, what is the weirdest thing you're into?
What does that mean?
I can't say that. They can still hear me. I'd have to mute myself.
Then mute yourself. I mean, come on, man.
I love when you carry
it's
man.
Not that complicated. Bye, I'm muted.
It's a secret for me.
Okay. Is it?
Military man. Ah! Like, you know, the Black Ops, you know, like, the Special Forces Epic. With the whole fucking combination and the helmet, you don't know what they look like. Ah! Like, you know, Call of Duty Ghosts. Ah!
Okay. Wait, I'm not muted. Uh-oh. Alright, well, my Discord crashed, so I'm, like, rebooting that real quick. I don't know what's going on right now. I think my Discord died. Alright. Give me one sec, guys. Alright.
I'm worried for your health,
they
not
can
your
hear us now.
On a roast.
Here it is. Well, bam. Alright! VR chat! Studio mode! Oh! Wait, where did they go? Hello?
Oh, no!
Oh, there we go! Hey! What up, mother truckers?
Yo!
Alright, I think we actually got it.
Whenever.
So listen up. Today we are with none other than all the way on the far end, just about Sinder. You may know her as Ellie, but I know her as Sinder. And next to her we have Saruei, a cybernetic bounty hunter. She was really hot for military men, so she became the woman she wanted to see.
Exactly.
And then next to her we have. That's pretty much it. All right, we're gonna begin the show started
just
today.
Just like her tweets. Motherfucker puts me out every time. I know you did it on purpose.
Okay, no, I love to be honest. I've ran out of characters on my tweets, so what can I say?
Shaking my head.
Yeah, no, it was a little bit unfortunate. You want to give me the real reason why you weren't on my tweet about the whole tier list thing or whatever?
What do you mean the real reason? I don't know what the real reason is.
The real reason is because I did not know which cards were given to you. Because you did not show them on your end, and I was not about to go look at the VOD.
I didn't want to download the PNGs and set them up.
Well, that's why you're not on my effing thing, okay?
It's very low effort.
Alright,
what do you
whatever.
Mean low effort? I make no thumbnail, Sinder.
Alright, let me go ahead and get this show started. Alright, effing. Let's get it for real.
Whenever.
Alright, so Snackers, we're joined by these lovely three fantastic contestants and friends of mine, I believe they're no longer in 140p. That looks pretty spectacular. Alright, so we're gonna explain the rules of the show right now. It's pretty simple. What we're gonna have going on here is basically two truths and a lie on steroids. Each of these three contestants, including myself, will give one story and we have to try and figure out if it's true or false, alright? So we're gonna start with an example prompt where they go ahead and talk about it. And then we'll ask them questions. At the end of it, we'll just say, oh, you know, I think they're lying, I think it's true. Whoever gets the most right at the end of the show wins. So that's pretty much it. All right, does that sound clear? Are we good to go there, chat? Give me an effing one if you understand.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
One.
Yeah.
One. Yeah, yes, we're gonna tell a story. So I asked these contestants to find random stories from their youth, okay? Either two of their stories are true and one of them's a lie, or two of them is a lie and one of them is true. We're gonna find out what it's gonna be as we go through. So yeah, some of these guys may be pathological liars. If they pick two false stories, I'm calling the cops. If they pick one false story, it should be easy to figure out, right?
I made one of mine of two truths, by the way.
Okay, you're not supposed to tell me. Wait, are you lying?
Are you not supposed to say that?
You might be lying. You might
Am
be
I lying?
Are you?
Is that allowed? Can I lie?
Stop. Okay, so, you know, some of these people...
gaslighter.
Some of these people may be serial killers. Some of them may just be friends with Neurosoma. We're gonna have to find out as we go through here.
Both an option.
Yeah, both were an option. You'd be in jail already. Alright.
What the fuck were yours? What does that mean?
Whatever. Anyway, today the show is called Positively... Wait. Possibly Possible. Frick. What is this
Possibly
called?
Plausible.
Whatever the frick. I don't remember what I named this song.
You made it!
This is way too complicated. It's got too many syllables, okay? I asked my ghostwriter.
She forgot me. She can't read the name.
It's the alliteration. It's like a tongue twister.
Yeah. So anyway, and it's got like the subtext. Like, it says, start the game. So yeah, pretty much it's a video game. We're gonna start the game. Who's ready for this effing junk?
What's up with the bottom text? What's going on there?
Start the game?
Start the game.
Yeah. Let's start the game! Here we go!
Alright, we're just gonna ignore that one.
Okay. Sinder, we're gonna go in this order. It will be Sinder telling her story at the first of each round, and then it will be Saruei, then Joel, and then me. Alright? Cool.
Let's
so
go.
We're gonna go ahead and get started. Sinder, feel free to read your example prompt. We're gonna begin asking you questions to figure out if your story is real or not.
Okay. Two guys broke into my house while I was home alone.
Were you actually home alone?
Yes.
Did they actually break into your house?
Yeah.
What frick?
Pretty kind of, yeah.
What do you mean kind of? Need more details.
Is it like there's a window?
They opened the front door.
So they weren't
in.
So they weren't through the open. Window, through the wall.
What the fuck?
She's effing good. She's pretty good. Okay, but like, was it just your dad coming home with his cheating wife? Were they actually like breaking in?
There were these two really big buff dudes.
Two big guys, okay.
Uh-huh.
Sounds like a porn to me.
Okay. But like, wait, what do they do? Do they traumatize you? Do they punch you in the throat?
Yeah,
Yes.
I was in the kitchen and I had a direct line of sight to my front door and I could see them walking in, so I hid behind the kitchen island and I was fearing for my life.
Wait, how old were you when this happened?
Way.
You're getting trauma dumped.
It was a long time ago.
What do you mean you don't know?
Yeah. Oh, that's weird.
I was younger.
You wouldn't
it was
remember
like,
oh, it was something that long traumatizes
ago.
You?
It was a long time ago.
In a galaxy far, far away?
In like grade school.
How many
younglings
did you kill, Anakin?
No. It was like one of the first times being left alone, I think.
I don't know. So what do they do? Did they just go and steal your couch and walk out?
She's fucking panicking.
Yeah.
They actually stole my parents' bed.
Why would they steal? Are they?
Okay, that sounds like a lie.
So they're just movers. So they're just moving people.
Why was there a pause between stole my parents and then bed?
Yeah, were your parents in the bed? Really, like, where did this get bad at?
The story has holes.
Were your parents in the bed or what?
No, I was alone.
Yeah, the FBI has the FBI.
That would make the bed a lot more valuable if the parents were in there. Her parents were very attractive.
I want to know what did you do?
Is bed like an analogy for like your jewelry or what?
No, like they
you
literally
stole your mattress.
Took their mattress.
Well, yeah. Is this the mattress that Drake sleeps on that costs like one
How
mil?
How good is the mattress?
Yeah, like this better knock you out like an effing sleep pill.
Did you keep the money in the mattress? Was there
no!
a hole in it where you shoved everything in there?
No, they walked in the house and just they took it. They walked into my parents' bedroom.
Are you There's sure?
No way they were- wait a second! Wait! Stop! I have an idea. Sinder's parents were goddamn drug dealers.
No.
Yes.
What? I don't know about that.
No, Sinder, they were hiding the coke in the mattress.
Did your parents say afterwards, hey, honey, we threw out the mattress because it had bugs in it, and you thought they were fucking, like, breaking in?
No! I had no idea why they were there.
Did you know later why they were there?
Yes.
So you do know it was something else!
Well,
Meet you later.
Still broke into my fucking house when I was home alone and I was traumatized.
So what were they there for? Do you know?
Look, when you see this...
Come on, you can share anything with the class.
Grill her until she tells the truth.
These two buff guys walking up... So the door was... It was, like a glass door. So the door had a big window on it.
Dang, okay.
And I could see them... From the kitchen, walking up...
With the candlestick?
My driveway and up...
she stared at them like, oh lord, they're coming.
I went to go hide! I was like, do I need to grab a knife? Do I need something to defend myself?
God. Imagine you're there to move someone's parents' like bed, and then their kid stabs you thinking you broke in.
Eren Yeager! Imagine dog's actually true and we're just making fun of her trauma.
Oh my god.
do they get caught for stealing a mattress?
No, because
what, they were too good?
it was their job. Mm-hmm.
I knew it!
Oh my god!
I knew it!
Wait, but did they actually break in though?
Yeah, like they walked up.
It wasn't illegal, but they broke in.
They broke in, yeah.
Okay. All right.
Sinder, you can't just come clean.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, now we know it's
could
true,
be lying.
No?
You don't know that. She could be lying right now.
I mean, yeah, okay, you're right. No, but no, if it's a true story, you have to tell the truth. When asked questions.
That's how that works.
So, like technically it fits the bill, they still broke into your house.
Uh-huh. I did not let them in. They walked. They just walked in. The door
was
unlocked.
Oh my god! You are literally cutting an effing door. You're doing surgery on a grape right now. Okay. All right.
Okay.
I think it's enough there.
I have my opinion on this.
All right. Okay. We'll go on to the next story, and then we'll go ahead and vote after we've all gone our first round. Okay. Let's get it. Next story. Joel, feel free to read and get it started.
I flirted with my best friend's mom.
Why are you gay?
Yeah, that's the truth.
I can see that being true.
Yeah.
What? No, it's not. First of all, this man doesn't even have
game.
That's
me.
When's the last time he had a girlfriend, huh? Friend? No, he's got no
game. I said best friend.
Well, I want to know. Joel's really big into moms.
I want to know. Like, did she flirt it back to you?
Well,
do you really think my best friend's mother would flirt back with me when I'm like...
Wait, after the TV show we watched...
Come on, just confess!
It's okay, but that's how we fucking flirted with my mom, dude!
Okay, but your mother's a very nice lady, and she's different. She's got, you know...
She's classy.
She's different.
She's not like the other moms. Joel, did she have it going on or not?
She did.
Okay.
It's been years though.
So could you pretend like I'm the mom right now?
Whatever.
I don't think
yeah.
I can even do that in my like I no, not directed at you, no.
Okay, okay.
Okay,
like,
just say what where you
basically
wait,
uh-huh. Every time I would go over to his house, I would look at her and I would
Okay. You got this!
I would literally look at her and it'd be like, looking good today, Mrs. whatever, like, last name is.
Yeah. So you
and
actually
there would be
really...
a variation on that every time I would go in, and it would be like a running thing that we did every time I went to her house.
You sound like you're an effing co-worker at an office job. You're like, wow, looking good today, Penny. You know how the stock chart's coming along.
You're the creepy co-worker.
You look great today. That's scary.
Oh my god, I really like that blue cardigan, like Cardi B. Like...
I really like how you look in that outfit.
Okay. Yeah, so basically you're Carl Weezer.
I would say Jimmy's mom when I would walk in. Okay. It was definitely Carl Weezer.
How long have you known your friend for?
Like 11 years.
So you were flirting with her the whole time?
No, I stopped after a bit.
What do you mean? Why? Like, why did you
it
stop?
It was only for like, it was for 2 years, and I was like, this is.
You flirted for 2 years?
What?
You've been going longer than my stalkers have.
She was not single.
Wow.
Well, of course, she's not single.
Well, I wasn't expecting it to go anywhere. I just wanted her to know that she was very young and beautiful, even though that she was my friend's mom. And I wanted her to know that she still had it.
Dog, you're glazing.
Alright. Oh, God.
Okay.
I just wanted she still was attractive.
Did your friend know that you were doing this?
He kind of just, like, ignored me every time I did it.
So you did it in front of your friend.
You traumatized your friend.
No.
That is Maybe. The biggest offense I've ever...
He wasn't traumatized.
How would you feel if every 2 years on effing command, when your friend saw your mom, you're like, dang, you're hot.
I mean, you know, she can do whatever she wants. She's a grown woman.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
She has her own life to live. I'm not going to stop her.
It's your friend, not her. She's getting catcalled in her own house.
She's not getting...
Yeah, you're the what type was... of guy like...
What was her response to your, flirting?
Well, I was like a kid, so she was just like, well, thank you. That's very sweet of you.
My kid old.
11 years ago, Joel. Little baby doll, Joel.
Probably like, I don't know, 16, 17-ish.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-mm. Oh, so you had raging hormones.
Okay!
That makes a lot
you
of sense.
You watched too many porn.
Hold on a minute, hold
and
on
he
a
got
minute.
That post-nut clarity, and he's like, maybe I shouldn't be planning with my bestie's mom.
Joel, so post-nut clarity not, hit 2 years
why
later?
Why not someone in the same grade as you?
I don't like anyone that was, like, in school.
Okay, so when you're, like, 40 years old, you're just gonna be into GILFs only, right? They gotta be, like, 60
as
plus,
older,
they gotta look an epic prune.
Progressively gets older?
Yeah, they gotta look an epic prune when they're done. Like, come on.
Every year, the age just
needs
to be older.
Yeah, and then when you're, like, 60 years old, you're like, they gotta be 1 foot in the grave. Like,
just show me the gravestone.
Okay. Oh! No! Okay. Okay, I think we have enough here for this story.
Hey, you never know what's real or not.
All right, Chris. All right, let's effing get it. Next one, Wazam. Saruei, it is your turn.
Oh. Okay, so I read it, right?
Oh, yep.
Okay. So I met a famous French band and had a chance to get the signature after sneaking in the backstage with the help of a friend as a bodyguard.
What? So you snuck backstage on a concert?
Yeah.
Who was the famous French band?
It was Carpenter Brut.
Carpenter
Brut? She said
Brut?
Cap. Cap was
yeah,
the
true.
Word.
Carpenter Brut.
What is pencil sharpener? What? Glute? How could it do anything?
It's French, Filian.
No, those are English words, are they not? Carpenter?
Carpenter Brut.
Carpenter Brut.
She could actually lie to us and none of us would know if it's real French or not.
It's true.
No, it is. Okay. It is. They are French.
They are French. Okay. Well, the French woman said it herself. let me see. So who
Did
is your
not have
friend?
Security?
Yeah.
He's a friend that I knew for like a few years. Met him in a bar.
Uh-huh. Met him at a What's bar?
Like?
Wait, you used to go to a bar?
What's his name?
Yeah.
Where does
time.
He live?
What's his social security number? What's his blood type?
But I don't even talk to him anymore, so I don't even record his name.
Oh my God!
he got you backstage, you don't even remember his name. The absolute disrespect
I mean,
there.
He's the one who, like, I invited me to go backstage. Was like, hey, dude, like, you know, I know somebody. Like, you know, we can go into backstage and shit, you know? That's
it. Well, actually, I think Joel had a question. Oh, you want me to ask it for you, Joel?
Yeah, what do you mean, do you want me to ask it for
yeah,
you?
Yeah, I'll ask you.
What are you
Joel
trying to
Joel wants to know if
me?
That man's mom was single or not. So, what do you
think? Know what? I'll ask. Fine. Yeah, is it... Huh? How attractive was he? You know? Can we base how attractive
Wait,
his
no!
mom is
That's
him?
So sus! Wait, you're trying to what? Base how hot the guy is for the mom?
Yeah.
Whoop.
You need Jesus. That's not how that
you're
works.
You're the one who asked the question, no, why are you Jillian.
Like, you're like, oh, I'm straight. Anyway, let me sniff your armpit. Yeah, your mom's
what
armpit
was his genetic
smells good too.
DNA sequence?
Oh my frick. You're like 23andMe. Like, what the frick? Mm-hmm.
I actually do have a question, though.
Uh-huh.
So, how did you ask your friend? Like, how did you convince your friend for this to happen?
Oh, he's the one who got the ID. Was like, I found like this badge on the ground, and I can give it to you, and you can like, you know, sneak in the backstage and like pass as a VIP.
It was just on
oh,
the
so
ground.
He just gave you a badge that somebody lost?
Yeah, exactly. From another
band.
Honestly,
I believe that if you went to TwitchCon, it was the easiest junk to sneak
skill
into.
Skill issue.
Oh boy, a lot of sneaking into every con that I've been to.
Uh huh. Okay. Yeah. So, I don't know if I buy it, but maybe.
I gotta see the others before we buy anything.
That's true. I mean, the thing is, like, Saruei, like, you know, she might have, like, one story that's false and two that are true. So, you know. I don't know. Did you get their signature or not?
Yeah, I did.
Were they like, who the frick are you?
Huh?
You were backstage. Were they like, who are
did
you?
Did they question you?
Yeah.
Oh, well, so they already knew my friend was a bodyguard. They knew I was a fan. And I asked for a signature and they gave it to me. And when I said who I was, I'm like, oh, I'm a big fan. He said, hi, fan. I'm Frank. And I'm like,
you got freaked!
Because this guy is a boomer. He's a boomer.
The dad jokes go everywhere.
That was honestly oddly specific. He said, let me be Frank. I'm Frank.
But your friend wasn't actually a bodyguard.
No, he was.
Oh, he was?
Yeah.
But he found the badge. Okay.
Found the badge? Yeah.
Okay. Any further questions, Your Honor?
So he just found the badge on the ground while bodyguarding?
I mean, yeah, Jay concert, people get drunk.
I mean, if he's walking around backstage and stuff, then maybe.
Alright, okay.
Yeah, Frank the Tank. Oh, I feel like every guy named Frank has to be a bodyguard. Like, it's like their rule.
Don't pin that on the Franks.
No, well, no, Frank is
the singer, right? Or the band?
Not singer, the synthwave guy.
Oh, right, he's the singer. Oops, my bad. Alright.
No, synthwave.
He does synthwave. A synthwave, yeah.
Nice.
He do OZ electronic.
Ooh. He did Optimus Prime music. Okay. Any further questions?
I think I'm good.
Okay. Next one! Filian. I framed my friend for clogging a toilet.
Yeah, this is pretty
That's
much
so
you.
Believable.
This is very believable.
It may be believable, but that does not mean it's true.
How did you frame
your friend?
One
clogging? Okay,
was
yeah, so I gotta explain.
House?
Yes. So, we're at my friend's house, okay? And, you know, I got, you know, a little bit of trouble in the neighborhood, you know? I made one little mistake, my mom got scared, the toilet was clogged, and I didn't know what to do in there, right? So, I come out the bathroom, and I need to hatch a plan fast as frig, because the toilet ain't flushing, I don't know how to operate a plunger, I don't even know if there was a plunger in there. And God knows, like, I ain't gonna be the one who takes the fall for it. So while she was upstairs, I went and found her mom, who was in the house, and I said, hey, you know, your daughter, she really is really embarrassed by this, but the toilet's clogged and she needs help. And the mom grabbed the plunger, she went in there and rectified the situation. So, yeah.
So you had your friend's mom clean up your shit.
That definitely seems like a Filian thing.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, okay, sure. I mean, so pretty much you guys are just gonna believe me just like that?
Yeah, I mean, this is pretty
good. Well, what if it's not true?
Is it true?
Yeah.
Yes, obviously, I'm supposed to say it's true.
So are you saying that you could have lied about this? You came up with this story out of
obviously,
nowhere?
Obviously, it's possible.
To say whether our stories were...
No, don't say if your story is true or not ever. Alright, according to you, all your stories are true.
Everything I'm saying is truthful.
Okay, I mean, does anyone have any further questions? You guys think I would actually do it? You know, any more circumstances?
I just feel like this is you.
Oh my god!
Wait, so your mom is friends with your mom's friend?
What? No. I was at my friend's house. No, their parents were not friends.
You and your mom were at your friend's house.
No, me and it was just me after school. over there.
At your friend's house, and then you told your friend's mom that you clogged the toilet.
Correct.
And then blamed it on him.
And then I blamed it on her, yes.
How did you clog the toilet?
How did I clog it? With my what? Oh, too much. I just toilet paper. Lots of toilet paper.
No, no, Sutter, you're right. I just threw
the whole roll in there. Do you wipe? Oh my god.
No, I...
Shit.
Stop!
It's not possible with like Vinian's shit, she can close the toilet, so she used a lot of toilet paper for sure.
I've regretted this right now.
Shit way too hard.
I fell and got stuck,
have a huge fucking shit.
Stop!
I thought you were talking about your
mom. You shitted, Filian.
What? No, it wasn't my... Okay, I was at my friend's house, her mom fixed it.
Sinder, she was at her friend's house. The friend's mom is the one who fixed it, and then she blamed it on her friend's mom's child.
No, what?
Can I ask, what were you
at the time? I blamed it on the mom's daughter, who was my friend. What's up?
Oh, what were you at the time?
I was probably around... This was, beginning of high school, probably. So I'm like 13 or 14.
You what? At 13 and 14, you had somebody else clean up your own shit?
Shut up! Dude, there's a full grown adults that need help. Okay, and she had two brothers, and they weren't there because they were doing football or whatever the frick.
So instead of the so-called friend going to the mom and explaining to the mom that the toilet was clogged, you had to tell her mom for her?
Yes, yeah, I know. It was the only thing I could think of. It was my...
That's possible.
I had to say she was embarrassed when in reality I was embarrassed, but you know? So, yeah.
Seems true.
Yeah, the mom totally knew.
Shut up! No, she didn't!
Oh, boy.
She would never know.
Really think your friend wouldn't tell their mom after you left that it was you?
But as long as you would ask, hopefully. Wait.
And that was the last time you were at
You'd
that
be surprised.
Friend.
No, she was a good friend of mine. I was there a lot.
And you were like, hey, yo. Well, hey, yo, girl, I need some help.
Oh, boy.
Okay.
Hey, at least you didn't like throw it out the window.
Whenever.
Yeah, whenever.
Listen, I don't even know if I want to
I tried to like hide
about
it.
This.
Okay. Alright. Okay. Alright, are we good?
I don't know what else to ask.
Oh my god, my face. Okay. Next one. We're at the end of the round. Okay. So we have completed the first round. It is time to vote on what we think is true or false. So I'm gonna do this, okay? I will type in Discord. Sinder won. Everyone who is not Sinder will go and type, you know, true or Y for yes and for no. AKA they don't believe it, okay? So Y if you believe it and one if you don't. All right, so, and then we'll talk about it, okay? So let me come over here. Bam, Lazam, Discord, here. All right, Sinder won. All right, you can type your Ys and Ns.
I won?
Yes. All right, do you believe Cinder's story? It's two guys broke into my house. You can type in there.
I'm opening. I got my phone, so
Sorry, don't type Sinder one. Just under it. Type N or Y.
I thought we were supposed to vote here.
No, just type N or Y. All right, it's Cinder's first story. Wait, do you guys see that? You guys can type in the Discord.
Wait, we're guessing before we see the other ones. We just do them each round.
Yes. Yeah. Each round.
Okay. So there's one. Yeah. Is there one true in these four? Is that what it is?
No. It's just every person has one or two true stories.
Okay, cool.
So pretty much you believe the story or not.
And so at the end, we're gonna like...
Tally it up.
Explain which one is
Yup. At the very end is the reveal.
Alright, let's see.
Alright, so put him back in there. Alright, so I'm gonna start off with me. I'm gonna be honest with you. Sinder, your story had more holes in it than the effing Watergate scandal. I mean, that thing looked like an effing pinata that got busted in half by the time we were done. I think you had two people that came and visited your house and they moved it, and you said, let me just pretend like they're broken. And you didn't realize people would be asking if you got traumatized or not.
It was traumatizing.
It would have been traumatic if it was true. Or, yeah, maybe, I don't know. Alright, and then let me see. We'll go up next to, Maid. Do you believe Cinder actually had two people break into her house?
I feel like it's a true story because I can see Cinder freaking out about this kind of thing. I feel like I've heard about her talking about big burly men before, so maybe it's just like the back of my head thinking about this.
Oh my god, was this Ram Ranch?
I feel like it's true. I can imagine Sinder freaking out about this. She's the type.
And she's then getting the type?
Confused later. Yeah.
So you're saying she thought two guys broke into her house, but they didn't.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Okay, well, I think in that case, they didn't actually break in.
Well, then are we going... That's semantics, then.
Yeah, I know. We have to figure out the semantics here. Okay, so here's what I'm thinking. Okay, You have to think that people legitimately broke into Sinder's house with negative intentions. That's the rule. Do you believe
that? Okay, well then no.
Alright, the answer's no then. Alright!
Whenever, please.
And Saruei, are you gonna amend your answer? You can change your answer.
I mean, it was yes, but if we take the charity, like, what is right, then I would say no.
Like, no, the story has to be true as she said it. Two guys broke into her house. Like, she based off the fact that people visited, that doesn't count. Like, that's partly true, you know?
I mean, is it breaking into a house when you had an appointment to move?
Sinder, you can't pretend to be Johnny Depp's lawyer, okay? You said they broke into your house.
I did not willingly let them into my house.
What if that's one of her truths and then we get it wrong because you were playing...
Sinder! How do you want to frame it?
Is this real? Answer it right now. Is this real?
Okay, how do you want to frame this, Sinder? Give us a story, alright? And then we'll vote yes or no.
What do you mean?
Did they break into your house or you thought they were breaking into your house? What's the story that we're voting on?
I thought they were breaking into my house.
Okay, you thought it. Okay, cool. Well, I'll say yes, true.
Then yes.
Okay, alright. Okay. I'm saying true too then.
I'll change my answer to yes. Okay. Edit message. Here. Alright, and then the next one we're gonna do is Joel 1. Alright. So you guys can type yes and no underneath it. Do you guys believe that he flirted with his best friend's mother?
yeah. Yeah, so that yes.
Yeah.
Real right, or false?
All right, Saruei, why do you believe him?
Because last time with Sinder, he invited us to watch MILF Mansion or something like this.
Wait, we think
that he likes MILF, so it's like it happened
on that show.
No, yeah, they were all ugly. We agreed on that. But the fact that you took interest into that show got me. Oh yeah, he likes me. If you want to see sexy bitches here,
Joel, let's say if the MILFs were like really hot and really nice.
No, their personalities were still like the things they did on that show were still really fucking weird.
They were a part of the show though. They had to do special challenges.
It wasn't a challenge. One of them got traumatized because she fucked like his best friend or something.
Yeah! What is going? What?
No, spoilers, by the way.
Oh yeah, because I'm gonna watch that. That's so bad,
hey,
dude. I can't
it's believe. It's good you... content.
Ooh, good thing you didn't spoil Attack on Titan. Like, holy frick. Okay. You know, Joel.
I never watched it.
Cringe. I believe you because I've been ranting about fruit snacks before I became a streamer, and fruit snacks, just like MILFs, are your entire personality, as is mine. You know, so
I'll take it.
I'll believe you
I'm
when
not
you say
fight that.
That. Yep, that's my thought. All right, Sinder, what are you thinking? You just believe?
Oh yes, definitely.
All right. Okay. Up next we're gonna have Saruei. I snuck backstage to get an autograph. Saruei 1. All right. What are we thinking right now?
Yeah.
Okay.
There was like really specific details.
Uh-huh.
That like, you know, if you recall something happening and you remember the conversation that they had.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah, it was kind of sus the way it worked out, but it's like, you know, like the dad joke that he said back to her. I'm like, oh, like usually you only recall conversations when they actually happen.
Okay. That's valid. I'm gonna counter argument. The fact that her friend happened to be a bodyguard at this person's concert is very convenient, and the fact that Saruei happened to go to that same concert. He also happened to find a pass, and then he happened to find her to give it to her, and then they happened to go backstage where you can meet her. I'm not buying it. I think it's plausible, but I don't think it happened.
It's plausible, but it feels like it's a lot of niceties. I don't know.
But it also wasn't her idea.
Oh, where am I?
You're on the second round for some reason, though.
Yeah, all right, we're good. All right, we're good.
I'm gonna go with Filian. I don't think it's real.
Okay. All right.
I hear you laughing over there.
All right, it's time for the final of these first rounds. Filian 1. Dun, dun, dun. All right, go ahead and vote. Please don't type yes too fast. Oh my god, stop!
She could be lying. This could just be a very, like, this is a Filian thing she's done before, but maybe this isn't specific. But I don't know. I feel like I can see Filian, like, I can see her doing this.
Oh, 100%.
Getting herself in the ass and somebody's mom to clean it up for her.
Okay, it's something I would do, but...
That is the point. Maybe she is lying.
I don't know.
Maybe we can regain some more faith in Filian and assume that she's lying.
I'm trying to guess. What's...
Or am I?
I can only hope that it's a lie. I can only hope.
It's up to you. It is up to you.
Chat, yeah, you can vote, Chad. Enjoy,
Chad, you guys can
the
type
vote.
Too.
Yeah,
Chad,
yeah.
Log in.
Yo, Chad, give me Y's and N's.
Yeah, whenever we're doing this, just type Y or N if you believe it or not for each lie that we're doing. What do you guys think about Phil?
What?
Damn the Y's, let's see him. Come on, what do you think about Philly?
Everyone's typing yes, bro.
Not an N in sight.
Bro.
Oh
okay.
My god.
All right, Saru, what's your vote? What are you thinking?
I love democracy.
Wait, about, like, which one?
The Filian, I framed my friend for clogging the toilet.
Oh, yes. You were so awkward about it, so yeah.
Ah! Okay.
Maybe she's a good actor.
Yeah.
Nah, she's not.
Oh, okay. Well, sorry, make sure to type a Y if you believe it.
Oh, shit, sorry.
Yeah, you're good. Okay. So pretty much the only person that got, like, knows was Sarway's first story, which, you know, statistically speaking, checks out. Alright, cool. You guys ready for the second round then?
Yeah.
No. Right.
No.
No. I say let's go.
Oh, let's go.
Yeah.
Let's go. LATSGO. Yeah. All right, Sinder. Let's see what we got here. Go ahead, and take it away.
I raised a family of skunks and fed them scrambled eggs.
What are you, Lord of the Flies?
What the hell?
Why specifically scrambled eggs instead of like raw or anything else?
Well, we need to feed an animal raw eggs?
Yeah, a lot of animals get fed raw eggs because they can break down the shells and get some like nutrients.
Yeah, but how is she going to know that if she's like 12? Wait, Sinder, how old were you?
Like a teenager.
Okay. Is it like a 13 or is it like a 19?
No, it was maybe like 16.
Okay, middle of the pack. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Why skunks?
Yeah, why skunks?
I found them. I found them outside.
Okay, so if you find a black bear, you shouldn't adopt it.
What was your first reaction to seeing them?
Aww.
Wrong! It would be, oh my god, they smell!
No, wait, skunks don't
they
smell,
don't
they
smell
know,
right?
Right
away.
Yeah.
It's only when they
speak,
no?
I think it's only the ink.
Oh, so
no,
now you're saying they're stinky.
They were scared of me.
How did you get them to follow you? Or what? Like, yeah. What did you do with them? Did you just leave them there?
We found the mother dead. And they had...
Oh my god!
They had a whole,
not a full,
like,
family then, huh?
Yeah, well, they had a dead... Oh my god, Joel.
You adopted
well,
Batman.
There was a lot of babies. There was a lot of babies. And there were scared babies. So, I got really stinky. My dad was there helping. And they were underneath, like, they're in, like, a hole.
Where? Or in a city or the woods? Like,
wait, how'd you find them if they were in a hole? Were you looking around for the hole?
You're like, oh, yeah, the dead skunk. Mother. Let's find their babies.
And the babies were around the dead mother.
In the hole?
Oh.
And they were in a hole by the dead mom.
Yes.
Okay.
Where was this hole? Was this in the middle of the woods or a city or what?
Did the mother die in the hole? Or was
it
above the hole?
It was next to my house. Yeah, she was dead in the hole.
So how'd you see it in the hole?
It was next to my house.
Were you outside? Were you walking? Or did you see it from inside of your house?
Yes, I was outside my house.
Okay.
So you got morbid curiosity from seeing a dead animal and walked towards it.
The babies were walking around it.
In the hole?
Around the hole or in the hole?
Yeah,
both. They were everywhere.
How many babies?
How many were there?
How many babies? Yeah.
Six? Around six?
Jesus.
Did you name them?
Did you pay child support?
No.
How long did you take care of them for?
Until they broke out of our makeshift enclosure.
I believe
that. What was the makeshift enclosure like?
It was like that rubber. It kind of looks like chicken wire, but it's like the orange rubbery kind of.
You just had chicken wire around?
Yeah, my dad likes to build stuff, and he had like things laying around the garage.
That is the most suburban daddy I've ever heard in my life.
Your dad is a resourceful man.
So much of the story checks out, but some of it doesn't to me.
I can't trust that.
Okay, so like you googled, oh, what'd you scrambled eggs. And, then Google said scrambled eggs. That's what it said. Like, oh yeah, give them beans, toast, scrambled eggs. You know, tuck them in.
How did you raise them with the smell if they were consistently scared of you? I find it hard to believe that they'd be okay with you after one day after their mother died.
Well they're babies. Can they? Yeah. Okay.
And then why scrambled eggs?
So, why scrambled eggs?
Why scrambled eggs?
Said so.
My scrambled eggs were so good that they stopped smelling skunky. They were just so cool with me.
They were usually huddled in one corner together of this little enclosure we made them. Because we didn't want to have them, like, be attacked or, you know, like, picked up by a predator, bird, or other kind of animal. Yeah, a predator. So, whenever we would go out and feed them, my dad and I, we would cook up some scrambled eggs and put them on, like, a little paper plate or something, and we would just leave it on one side of the little enclosure we made for them. And
so you'd never go too close to them. You would just leave the food out for them.
Right. We just wanted to take care of them enough so that way they could get big enough on their own and then be able to survive easily.
What was your endgame goal? Oh, just okay. I see.
But I feel like your dad would know not to mess with wild animals.
That seems
skunks.
Possibly plausible.
This is definitely a plausible thing.
It's possibly plausible. Hey, Bazinga! Alright.
She said the title.
That's me. Alright,
Okay, Frick. I don't have any more questions.
It's pretty hard because
you
cannot see.
How did your mother feel about this?
My mom? Oh, yeah. She thought they were cute.
What do you guess so much about everyone's mom?
Well, she's a part of the family. I would assume the mother would have something
to
say about
you're
skunks.
You're trying to become part of their family.
Yeah,
jeez,
I
my mom complained of the smell.
So it was smelly. Okay.
Yeah. They were spraying us just when we were trying to collect all the babies.
How often did you get inked?
Just that one time when we were first running around trying to catch them.
How long did it take
you? Did
you
have to argue with your
what
mom?
What happened when you got inked? Like, what did you do to clean up? How long did it take?
I had to wash the outfit I wore dozens of times. Because it just kept smelling like skunk.
What does skunk smell like?
Like weed.
Like weed and
weed?
Piss.
Wait, really?
Yeah.
Weed?
Yeah. Not good.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, I didn't know that.
Apparently cheap weed smells like skunk.
Ew.
Already?
Is what I've heard.
They'd be farting chemicals.
I thought it would smell like stronger than this.
Dude, you know how many stars are gonna go effing milk a skunk now? Like...
I don't like the smell, but
Zaza!
It was worth it because they were cute.
Your whole family was into this? Like, everyone was okay with the idea of you just raising skunks?
Yeah.
Okay.
Wait, and how long did you raise them?
Before they left.
Maybe a couple weeks before they ended up breaking out of the enclosure. They kind of dug a little hole and broke out of the fence.
No!
Yeah.
They're gone.
One day we went to go check on them to feed them eggs and stuff, and they were gone.
She said eggs.
You were feeding them only scrambled eggs because that's not really healthy to just give them this.
There wasn't
eggs
anything else that we knew to feed them.
Okay.
I mean, it was a while ago, and I distinctly remember the eggs.
Ah, okay.
Sinder, I have a question.
Yeah.
Why didn't you name one of them Elon Skunk?
This was before Elon was a...
Yeah.
Oh, come on. So boring.
Was a meme.
Okay.
This is before the cat girl era.
Alright. Cool. Alright, are we good? Are we good here?
I think so, yeah.
Alright. Well, bam, we're gonna go on the next one then. Shing! Joel!
I once tried to eat my phone.
Were you trying to take a picture of your insides? Like, what was the goal?
I can explain it, so...
Okay, yeah, you better. Like, what?
I hope so.
Basically,
you tried to eat your phone.
What happened I've never been drunk or high. I was groggy, right? And I had an alarm come up, so I would wake up for school because I was really tired before. So what happened was I left the alarm on, and then the next day, it's not a school day. So I wake up, the alarm for some reason was fucked up. It's like 2 to 3 a.m., and I'm just groggy as fuck. And in my brain, I think when I open my mouth, noise comes out. If I close my mouth, the noise stops. So if I bite my phone, the noise will stop. So
what?
I bit my phone, and then I went to bed because the noise stopped. And then I woke up and the phone was like cracked. and I felt like groggy, like crumbly bits in my mouth.
Are you having Like, what? Why is the solution Eden? Like, what?
That was such a dumb solution to that problem.
I was groggy, bro.
My brain wasn't working properly. I was like, open mouth noise, closed mouth no noise.
What the frick?
I don't trust your story.
No, dang, you still sir, hear like, it.
Well, ask
you
me questions.
You still hear the alarm.
Yeah, true. Like, yeah. Have you ever had a tooth tune before that the toothbrush goes bam 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 in your throat?
Oh,
you know
my
what I'm
god,
saying?
Yeah.
I did have one of those.
Yeah, so then you would know that you could still hear it. In fact, you can hear it even louder once it's in your mouth.
You can believe what you want, but I'm telling you that's what happened.
Okay. I ain't buying it.
Maybe it was so loud it busted his eardrums and there was blood shooting out of them. Like, I don't know. Are you sure this wasn't a dream, Joel?
No, it was real because I woke up with the cracks in my mouth.
All right.
I had like a little bit of the fucking phone glass in my mouth.
Ooh, delicious.
Yummy.
They're magically delicious.
The cracks.
All right, I mean, this story seems pretty effing simple. Well, that we believe it. The question is, do you think Joel's IQ is low enough to take a chunk out of his phone?
Nah.
When I was younger and groggy,
remember,
yes.
If you say no, that means you think he's intelligent. Well, that's a really hard
you? Because you gotta bite down really fucking hard to crack your goddamn phone screen.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's because if it's an old one.
Well, it's not like I had a Nokia.
Was
I had
like
a fucking
an
Windows
or a
phone.
Like
no,
wait,
I had
yeah,
a Windows
so it wasn't
phone.
An iPhone?
I had a Windows phone.
What the frick is a
I
Windows
played
phone?
Xbox games on them.
What is a Windows phone? Windows
Xbox. Phone. Microsoft made a phone that was that you could play Xbox games on. So I bought that because I wanted to get achievements.
And then you ate it.
And then I bit it.
Okay.
It does look sensitive.
Did you take it back
it's
in the store?
It's a good
act,
like, did it wasn't.
Did
no,
you take
I kept
it in the
using
store
it. No, I kept
so
using it.
So it had teeth marks in it.
What did it taste like?
Glass, Sinder. Or like the plasticky glass thing.
Alright, my guy eats petrochemicals on the weekend. I think this one's pretty clear to me. Alright.
That's why I'm dead and turned into a porcelain doll.
Was
it was the fiberglass.
I can imagine you put up a picture of someone's mom and then just took a chunk out of it. You're so hot.
What do you think MILF lovers are like? They bite moms? What the fuck?
I don't know. What if the MILF is into biting? Like,
yeah, I don't
know.
That
doesn't seem very unreasonable.
Are you trying to tell me something, Cindy?
I'm not a MILF.
That's I mean, not- wait, what? What?
That's not what I was talking about. I wasn't bringing up you.
Okay. Interesting
I don't
confession.
What the hell?
You did sing CPR in front of your mom and dad before, though. Yeah? Yeah. What?
Yeah, they like to watch my streams, so...
Cool. Are they watching right now?
I don't... Maybe.
Hi, Cinder's mom!
Hi, Cinder's
Hi,
mom!
Hi!
Whoa! Wait, she's here! Holy shit, chat!
Is she?
It's Cinder's mom! Look at her!
Wait, who? Where?
Yo!
What?
He's got a PNG of my mom!
Oh my god, what?!
It's Cinder's mom, bro!
Why would you ever show Joel your mom?
I love Mama Wolf!
Oh,
let it go!
Stop! Dude, it's in his effing collection on his desktop.
Let's go!
He has this image of my mom at the ready every single fucking stream.
Jesus Christ. Okay.
And your dad is here too, but I don't have him open yet.
Okay. Alright, okay. No, don't. Wait, there's someone named Fred in my chat who's verified. Is that the original Fred? From YouTube? What is that name? Alright. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I'm ready.
Yeah. Alright, next one! Bum bada bum! Alright, Saruei's you.
Oh. Alright. I once got stuck in a revolving door and had to be rescued by the building security.
What?! Help, step security, I'm stuck! Like,
help
what?
Me, step chat, I'm stuck in the door!
Ah, no!
Yeah, it's pretty awkward.
By the way, I have a question for you. How? Mm-hmm. How?
So, basically, someone dropped something, behind, like, the revolving door, like, one of the revolving door, and it got stuck between, like, you know, the door and also, like, the circular, like, thingy. I don't know how to call it. Mm. And it wouldn't, like, you know, move, even after pushing it really, really hard.
I believe this one 100%. Yeah, I can really believe Saruei getting stuck in a revolving door.
How long were you stuck?
You got put into a human-sized jar.
Maybe like around 10 to 20 minutes before they actually started to have the security coming over.
20? Wait, hold on a minute. 20 minutes in a revolving door is a long time.
No, 10 minutes.
So you're like banging on the glass?
People are needing to go into the place.
It was about 10 minutes, I don't remember because it was a while ago, but we were pushing at first, we tried on our own, and then, like, you know, more people were coming and realizing they cannot enter, like, by the revolving door, and I had to take the over door, and then finally someone came up to us.
You got turned into a zoo exhibit.
Yeah,
that's
exactly that.
Hey guys, look at the
VTuber! Of being a VTuber.
Well, yeah. Laugh at the silly VTuber.
That's how you do an off-kind meetup.
Door.
Yeah, that's an off-kind meetup.
And then she decided to make it her entire career by being a VTuber.
Dude, Twitch channels are just zoo exhibits. Let's be honest with ourselves.
Well, it's kind of like the
funny,
same
mentally ill anime girl.
Just watching you from behind the screen.
So, how did it feel when you were stuck in there? Like, what'd you think?
Awkward and humiliating.
Did you like sit down or like what?
Do you feel that same way about Twitch streams?
No, I wouldn't sit down. That would be even more awkward.
Why? I would sit down frame one.
Did somebody else get help or did you have to
Floor is like dirty. Oh, well, because people couldn't go by the revolver door and they had to go to like, you know, the next entrance that just have a regular door. Mm-hmm. They went to the lady at the entrance to ask for help. Mm-hmm.
So like
and you didn't like
system.
You didn't call for help at all. You waited for other people to do the work for you.
I mean,
how
do you want me to like you know talk to anybody inside the building to like help me out?
Yes, that was
me.
Can
I get help?
I'm stuck inside.
You just like call the receptionist.
I can believe the social anxiety.
Hey, I'm
anxiety.
In the revolving door right now. Can you get somebody over here?
Hello, I'm under the water.
I can believe her having the social anxiety of not wanting to fucking call for attention to get help.
That's me.
No, it's just I was stuck and they did
how,
before
how did they get you out?
Well, they keep pushing and with like about 3 or 4 men and finally he just you know removed it and like whatever object it was that got stuck got broken.
Oh,
Were you in there by yourself or was there somebody else like?
No, thankfully I had like.
There's
a
no way
with Saruei. Me.
Oh really? Oh wait.
That's a big ass revolving door.
Why are all of your stories about touching grass? You're making us look bad.
Ah, maybe just a while ago.
Okay. Before you were a VTuber?
Whenever.
Yeah, just before I became a VTuber.
Okay, before she stopped touching grass. Okay. All right. Any further questions?
How big was the revolving door? Like, was there enough space for you and your friend in there?
No, yeah, it was big enough.
Was it like a Mr. Beast
was
video?
Was it tight?
I spent 10 minutes telling my
life.
Oh my god, we wasn't a porn! It's not a porn, like, kind of scenario.
Oh no!
It was wide enough, we were not stuck against each other.
No.
It was like having Japanese doujinshi plot.
was Saruei it...
Chan.
Like, how did it get... I'm trying to think of how it got stuck. If it's a big revolving door, I can imagine it getting stuck easier than a small one, but goddamn.
Wait, like...
It was an average size, I don't know.
The door was an average size.
I don't remember precisely how big it was.
You've never seen a big revolving door, Joe?
The one at WeebCon was small. That's like the normal size that I see.
Guys, oh, no, it wasn't a small one. It was average. It was
kind of average, guys.
Are you trying to say it's
like
average?
Three people can fit in.
It's average.
Okay. Like, we could fit 4 of us in that in one of those sections of the revolving door. Like, it was
but
less
10
small.
Minutes in there would be pretty uncomfortable with somebody else.
So, how good was his personality?
Wow, the door. How is the door's
the
personality?
Door?
Yeah.
You did not any.
Aww.
What a boring door.
So, he don't
door.
Respect you. Alright. He's
okay,
average but got
no
personality.
Questions.
No further questions on my end too.
I rest my case.
Okay.
Can we move on?
I case my rest. Let's get it. Next one! Bam! Oh, it's me! Let's go. Alright. I asked the plane pilot if I could have a mile high badge.
I don't believe
it. What is a mile high badge?
No.
I don't believe it. There's no way Filian would ask this to somebody in public.
No.
Yeah, she's too shy for this.
Like, tell your friend that you shat in their toilet.
Yeah, this
okay,
is not
no.
true.
Okay,
no, okay. Wait,
you guys have to ask questions. You can't just say yes or no for my stories without asking anything.
Again, you forgot to, like, put the, like, votes from before in the chat.
Wait, what?
From the Discord.
No, we do that at the end of each round, right?
At the end of the round. Is that
okay.
I have a question.
Someone asked me a goddamn question.
Filian, yes. How the fuck would you ask somebody about the Mile High badge when you get freaked out every time I talk about MILFs, which is such a normal thing?
Yes.
It's not the same.
It's pretty simple to explain, okay? So, okay. Like, do you know what the Mile High Club is?
No.
It's when you
sex in a plane.
Yes, because you're really high up in the air. When you fornicate in an aero vehicle while it's operating.
She would never ask somebody with the Mile High badge if she uses the word fornicate to describe sex.
Sorry, what is the Mile High badge?
Sorry, do you know the show Snakes on a Plane?
Fornicate.
Wait, what?
Do you know the movie Snakes on a Plane?
Let's talk at the same time. I'm being confused.
Yeah. Okay. Do you know the movie Snakes on a Plane?
I know it, but I never watched it.
It's like that, but instead of snakes, it's sex on a plane.
It's nothing like that.
Because
you asked a big pilot to have sex with you?
Because you're a mile high in the air, that's why it's called the Mile High. You're having sex at a mile high in the why it's called that.
Okay. Sorry, does it make sense? Okay, so if you have sex on an airplane, it's called the Mile High Club.
Okay.
Okay, because you become part of the club of people that have done it a mile in the air.
It's okay. Like the whole...
Okay, it's the kilometer like high club. Are you good now?
Okay,
the
but...
excitement of potentially getting caught is what people are into when they do that.
Okay, so if you ask a pilot to have a mile high badge, it means you had sex with somebody in the plane.
No, okay, so here's... Okay, so here's what I gotta explain, okay? Let me get the context. Okay, I am an idiot. I was a young child. Okay.
Oh.
Okay, and so what I knew was that the plane pilots, if you got the plane and landed down, you could ask them for a badge. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And so I heard of the Mile High Club, and I assumed that was like what you got for flying on a plane. You were a mile high, you were a member of the Mile High Club.
Where
the
fuck did you hear that
cool
from?
Kids achievement thing. Okay, so combining the fact that I said, okay, well, I get the free badge that they give the little kids, you know, after we land, which my mother told me was a thing. I said, okay, I don't know what it's called. So I went up and said, hey, can I get the Mile High badge? Because I was really excited to get my badge.
Your that's mom told you about the Mile High badge?
No, she said you can get a badge. And I didn't know what to call it, so I called
where'd
it the Mile High badge.
You came up with the word Mile High badge.
Dog, I'm an effing, like 10 or 12 year old. They're gonna be talking about sex for no reason. Yeah, like.
You never heard this word before.
Yeah, I never heard about this until I was like fucking 16, bro.
Okay, when well, I actually was on the internet
now.
Or something. Like. Yeah, well, sorry, it's different if you're French. Frig!
Is it?
They can
learn
about doesn't even exist in French.
Oh
wait,
my gosh. My
high badge.
Is there like
in
a
French.
special name for it in French?
Yeah. Do they have a name for it in French?
I cannot find anything.
Okay. Well, okay, in English speaking world, it is a term. When I hear mile high, I don't know exactly, but I'd heard the term before. I didn't know what it meant, and I figured I was part of the club, so I asked for the badge. Because
so,
I knew I could get a badge. Do you guys remember that? Wait, do you guys remember?
Did you get the badge?
Yes, I got a badge. Yes. Over his laughter
Jesus
reaction.
Christ.
And my mother's haunted, horrified face. Yes. I did get the badge. You guys remember that, right? Like, the pilots would give, like, little complimentary badges to the kids to be like, yeah, you're a pilot.
We got pictures. I never got a badge.
I got a badge.
Okay, it's not a French thing at all.
Got it. Okay.
So you were actually able to talk to the pilot?
Yeah, when you land, the pilot's like standing there.
Yeah, if you're a kid, you can go up to them and say like, hi, because they'll be like, hey, do you want a badge or like a picture?
Yeah, it's like the army funnel, you know?
Wow.
It's like, you know, that's it's like, wow, you can do a lot of pull-ups. Want to be in the Marines, you know?
It's only weird if you're like an adult asking them like, hey, can I get a picture? Can I get a badge?
Yeah.
It's, I mean, it's not that weird, but it's like, nobody does that.
So now you can say you're part of the Mile High Club.
Exactly. No. So anyway.
I think this is fake.
Okay.
I don't believe it either.
Do you guys have any further questions?
Nah.
Excellent. All right, we're gonna go ahead to the voting phase of round two. Pushing.
Let's go.
All right. Oi. So here we go. So we're gonna go ahead and get voted. I'm gonna type in Sinder 2, and we'll get
Chad,
started.
Chad, do you guys think Cinder's real or not real?
Sinder too. Alright, so here it is. Sinder said, no? I raised a family of skunks. Yes or no? We can start off with that.
What do you think, Joel?
I don't think it's real.
I don't think it's real either.
I refuse to believe everyone in the family would agree to raise the skunks. They are convinced hard.
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna be honest, I think 95% of the story checks out because it's based on truth. However, the part about the holes and the dead body in the discovery phase of this whole thing...
It was weird.
A little bit suspicious to me.
She had holes in those holes.
Or maybe she's just by the
there
thing
are
of
holes
story.
In this house, there are holes in this house. Frick. I'm gonna go
Why
forwards.
No, chat? Why N?
Alright! Let me go ahead and type my vote too. Sinder, after due deliberation, I do not believe you. Alright. We're gonna go on to the next one. Joel, I tried to eat my cell phone.
It's real and true.
Hell no.
No.
First off, I think you're dumb. Second off, I don't think you're that dumb.
Yeah, we agree.
Which is
you don't
really
think
surprising.
A 15 to 16 year old would get stupid enough and groggy in the middle of the night after being
nah.
at school
no,
all the
a,
time?
A 15 year old would get embarrassed of clogging a toilet, not eating their cell phone. That's like something you do when you're like 4 years old with crayons, you know?
No, I took responsibility if I was a kid and I clogged the toilet. I'd be like, I'm gonna clean this up myself.
Okay, but like, it's less embarrassing if you're a guy.
What does that mean?
It is!
She was in your chat when you brought her picture out.
That's right, baby! We love Sinder's mom!
Okay.
We said frick.
I love when she watches my streams. Thank you, Sinder's mom!
Oh my god, you're farming plus one viewers from your friend's mother. Oh my god.
You think this is about viewership? No, this is about the fucking bond that we're forming.
I'm gonna stop. Okay.
Yeah.
Live for real, man?
Let's go.
Okay. Okay. Let me ask you one final question, okay, Joel?
Okay.
What did people
whenever,
think about your cell phone?
Like,
did anyone ask you questions about it?
Yeah. Actually, I got questions about it all the time. And whenever I did, I would show them, like, look, I just got an achievement. Because I would play, like, really shitty phone games and get achievements because I liked achievement hunting back then to get the numbers, higher and bigger.
Gamer score.
Yeah, gamer score. I would literally show them, like, look, I can get achievements on it. And then all the people that played Xbox were like, wow, that's pretty fucking cool. And everyone else who didn't play Xbox is like, you're fucking, just get a normal phone, jackass.
What did it do with teeth marks?
Yeah.
Okay. So when you bite something like that, you're not going to get teeth marks. It's going to crack, but when you bite, like, let's say you break glass, it's not going to have an indent. It's going to be shattered.
Right.
But
I don't believe this guy at all. I don't
believe this guy. You said that you put it in your mouth so that you wouldn't hear the alarm, right?
Well, I put it in my mouth and then bit it.
Who deep-dosed technology to stop sound?
And then you fell back asleep.
Here's the thing. You guys got to realize that if I touch
a
phone... No, if
dude, you were huffing glass while you were asleep.
If I touch, okay, a phone's touch screen can be activated by not just a finger. Some of them get activated by a lot of different things.
I don't know because I have long, sharp, pointy nails, and those do not work.
Okay, a nail is a different thing than whatever's inside of my mouth.
What?
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. Wow, his nails are way cooler than yours.
You guys believe it or disbelieve it. I'm just telling you it's the truth.
Let me go put in the thingy. Wait, you guys are typing too fast. We didn't even get to Joel yet.
Chat, YN, do you think I'm right or wrong?
Twice. Sinder, you gotta delete your message real quick. Alright. Oh. Joel 2. Alright, let's vote now.
Yeah.
Alright. Joel, putting it down? Yes or no? Alright.
No.
That story is simple, but
whenever,
I don't believe
whenever,
it.
Whenever, whenever, pluggy, luggy.
Alright, it looks like we're all in agreement. Dang, this round's like three... So many no's, holy frick. Alright. Next one! Saruei, I got stuck in a revolving door. I'm gonna be honest
that
with you.
That seems pretty likely to me.
Saruei, if you get stuck in a revolving door, just give up. It's just like...
Oh, no.
Where's that fighting spirit, Saruei?
Instead of finding,
it's like a raccoon that sticks its hand in a trap and grabs like the treat, and it like refuses to let go and escape. Yeah. You guys know about the raccoon hand trap thing, right?
Wait, what?
So there's this trap with raccoons, if you put something in that like can reach their hand in and grab their fist around it, but they can't pull it out because their fist is too big, they will literally hold on to it until you come and get them.
Aww.
It's so stupid. Anyway. Yeah. Anyway, they don't let go. Yeah. shiny. But yeah, I feel like Sarah is just like, oh, guess I'll die.
I can believe, bad. I think Saruei has the social anxiety to just like stay stuck in there and not call for help. So I feel like it's pretty believable.
Saruei, how did you pretend like you,
okay.
Did you pretend like you were in control of the situation?
She seemed so embarrassed about it too.
I didn't pretend anything. The time I realized I really was stuck, like people just already came and talked to the lady at the entrance of the shop.
Did you try to pretend like you weren't stuck?
No.
Did anyone walk into the glass and be like, oh, let me
just...
Why
is she just standing there inside the revolving door?
I was stuck because like the revolving door wouldn't move when people wanted to get through it.
Why or N if you think she's lying, chat?
Did anyone actually try to like push on the door like to go through there herself, you know?
Well, yeah, they did try, but they don't want to break it, so they just decided to leave, like, the people, like, the security building guards to take over it.
Okay. Alright, I'm gonna open up the boat. Alright. Here we go. Saruei 2. Alright! There it is!
I'm gonna say yes.
My opinion. I believe you, Saruei. I do.
I believe it.
I believe that you got in there and said, guess I'll die. And then just sat there.
Me personally, I would have shattered the doors open and walked away.
Me personally, if I saw Cinder's mom on the other side of the door, I would have punched her with a magnum dong and just stood in front of her.
I wouldn't even break it.
I'm like the having Kool-Aid man combined with Jesus.
I simply phase through it.
Yo, phase up. Oh, they're going broke. Alright. Wait, Saruei, thank you for the 10 subs. Let's go! Thank you!
Yippee!
Here, Chad. Hey! Alright, it's time for round dress. One last
one. What about yours?
Oh, frick, you're right. Whoops. Alright, Filian said, I asked for a mile high badge. Alright, let me put this bad boy here.
Fake.
Yeah, this is fake.
Fake, real than real.
This isn't real.
Filian talking to people? Never.
I'm really talking to online.
Not like strangers. Person in public.
Actual people.
Have you ever seen me do a public lobby VR chat?
Well, that's different. Not
yeah, but you're like that. No, that, yeah, that's different because one, it's through that, and you have chat with you, like all.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Chat. Why do you think I can hold a conversation with a stranger in real life?
You know what they're gonna say. I don't know why you think they're gonna say anything different. You know what they will say. Chat, YN, do you think Filian asked for the My High badge?
Stop, you can't just crowdsource your answers.
No!
I already wrote my answer.
Fine, whatever. Okay, let me see. Everyone said no. F me. Alright.
Alright.
God! Okay, let's go on to the third and final round! Bum-ba-da-bum!
Let's see.
Sinder! Your turn.
I flashed my panties to a live audience.
What?!
Oh, yeah,
Jesus Christ! Okay, Sinder! It doesn't count if it's your V2 model, right?
No, it was...
What?!
Was it in the past 2 years?
No.
Okay.
This is the before times.
Mm-hmm. Or a VTuber. Oh! Wait, Sinder, are you a cosplayer?
Yeah. Yes. was this during a cosplay thing?
Yes, it was.
Was it during a convention?
Okay.
Or a stream?
Yeah, it was during a convention.
Okay. Were you on a panel?
Wait, was it by accident?
Yes, it was
by
accident!
I don't know, because I cosplayed it!
Oh my god. That's a thrill. Jesus Christ, bro. I don't know. I didn't think Sinder was going to be
god,
that.
I'm so sorry.
I was on a stage. And I tripped.
Okay.
How did you trip? Wait, what were you cosplaying?
True. What were you cosplaying?
Well, I don't want to like dox myself.
Okay.
Dog, you said you were a cosplayer at con, like.
Yeah. Okay. I was, and I would compete a lot.
Okay.
So I was on stage a lot. And I had these really tall heels on.
I bet you it was art for
oh, God.
I can believe heels fucking somebody up.
You would know. You probably wear heels every night.
What does that mean?
Joel.
Where does that even go? Where did that accusation even go?
You scream as a woman. Brig.
You scream as a woman?
Scream.
Stream?
Yeah.
And?
So you wear heels. IRL, I bet.
She's going with the gender norms, Chet. L. L. I don't even know what to ask about this.
Yeah, it just seems really believable.
How did you recover? Like, what did you do to recover? You just get up really quickly and then leave?
Yeah, pretty much. I stood up as fast as I could. And the people, when I walked off stage, they have these stage hands. And they're like, oh, are you okay? I was like, yeah.
Did you give you a round of applause?
No, it was kind of like, oh, like...
The audience collectively gasped.
Well, it'd probably be like, are you okay because you fell, rather than, oh, fuck, panties!
Yeah, it was because I fell.
Wait, why'd you say it like that?
Why'd you feel like that? What do you mean?
You see the intonation with her sounded weird?
Mm-hmm, no, like, no, because I didn't want you to assume that they were like, oh, I'm so sorry that you just flashed your panties to this live audience of thousands of people. Like, no, it wasn't that. It was like, oh, you fell, are you okay?
Hmm.
It's starting to come apart. Objection!
Wait, is it?
She's eating her fruit snacks. Leave her alone.
I'm eating fried rice.
It's just really fucking embarrassing.
Well, there is an option for two truths and one lie here, so I think it's true. I can believe it.
Yeah, me too.
Not so fast. I'm trying to think of the effing plot hole here.
I don't know, man. I feel like Sinder doesn't seem like someone to lie.
Okay, how about this? Sinder, why would you cosplay without safety shorts?
Because
that's the real question.
It's kind of hard. It's kind of hard to explain without
your pants were meant to be out in the first place with the cosplay. It doesn't make sense that you wouldn't wear shorts.
It was I wouldn't have been able to wear shorts with the kind of skirt. It was the kind of skirt that
like
I had.
Was it like a long skirt and it just flew up?
I tripped when I was turning to leave the stage. Because you hit your mark,
okay.
And then you turn around and leave. And that's when I had tripped.
Well, why could you not put safety shorts under a skirt?
Because of the accuracy.
The what?
Yeah, the accuracy. Is a cosplay.
You're not playing on shorts on your panties.
That's a fucking life
lesson.
Were
you doing it for a thrill?
No!
Yes!
That's a lesson to be learned.
It doesn't
always
make sense otherwise.
Shorts.
Because I would compete and I would be judged for my likeness to the character. And
they said, oh yeah, show me you're not wearing shorts on.
Okay,
face.
No.
It was like a casting couch.
They would not judge you on you wearing safety shorts.
Yes!
Like, that'd be
no,
really
literally.
Fucked up.
How would they know? How would they know you're wearing safety shorts?
Because, like, part of it is, like, exposed a little bit.
We're inspecting that for accuracy? Go fuck yourself. I'm gonna wear the safety shorts.
No. If it is,
I
would
wear the safety choker. I would. I'm on Cinder's side on this.
That would make the cosplay judges really fucking freaky if they were judging on that.
Yeah, like,
well, I mean, they might have said it was okay, but I'm the kind of person that's a perfectionist and I need to look exactly like
you.
Yes,
you just got a thrill out of it. I don't know if I believe it.
It's believable for me.
I think it's still believable, but
I would never.
That makes me mad
shirts.
That cosplay competitions would do that.
Uh-huh.
You know what? It's not here's necessarily the competition. It's me. It's my stubbornness.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Okay. Any further questions, Your Honors?
No.
Yeah.
Filian, do you have a switch? No, I'm a top. All right. Joel, it's... Sorry. Yeah, this one. All right, Joel, your turn.
I watched my boss get arrested in front of me.
Did you enjoy it?
So here's what happened, right?
Yeah.
Well, I can say that I enjoyed it. Fuck that guy. Well, here's what happened, right?
Uh-huh.
So I worked at a Little Caesars.
You spilled the tea. Oh my god.
My first job ever was Little Caesars.
Pizza.
And my boss was one of those types of people. So for example, right? He would go up to, let's say, me, and he would say to me, to my face, you know, Joel, you're one of the good ones. And I can tell you right now.
That's so manipulative.
I can tell you right now, he was referring as in race. He was a guy. He had a wife and kids, and whenever a woman came into the store, he'd be like, "You see that one?" Like, he would do shit like that.
He's actually a cartoon character. He's an actual cartoon character in real life.
He would walk into the store high. Like, he had, I don't know what drugs he was taking, but he would always come to the store on some kind of drug. He was on a high, basically. Even though, I can even tell more to this story. One time we had a new worker come in.
Just keep going.
He was this nice, wait, I'm giving you too much. Anyways, he was this nice Latino guy.
Wait,
he comes
in. I'm almost done triangulating.
And my boss is like, "Come with me." And then they leave. They leave the store. I don't see them for the rest of the day. I'm on closing shift. We leave. We close. Next day, I walk into the store. The fucking car is crashed outside of the Little Caesars, and I never see the other guy again. Like, the new worker just never comes in until 3 weeks later, and he calls on the phone. He's like, "I'm not coming into work today." And the dude, like, "Bro, you weren't coming to work the last 3 weeks. What do you mean?" I don't know what the fuck happened, but apparently my boss had been embezzling funds for years from this Little Caesars.
Wait, what is this?
Like, and he got arrested for embezzlement.
Yeah, it's literally the word for embezzlement. What's up, Sarah?
What is embezzlement?
Oh.
Embezzlement is like stealing funds and funneling them to you.
Yikes. So, can you tell me more? You said, "I watched my boss get arrested in front of me." I didn't hear you say you watched him get arrested yet in front of you.
Well, I went into the store the next day, and I was seeing the police cars out there, and I saw him getting arrested.
So, like, they literally went to his workspace while he was at his job and busted him.
Yeah, they arrested him at the Little Caesars!
Okay, so then the question is, how did they find out? Do you have any idea?
I don't know, I didn't ask.
Well, typically, there goes my boss!
I heard that it was embezzlement, and it's pretty obvious, because literally every time... Well, every time I would go there, like, when basically, he was a piece of shit, and he would send me off to the meetings for all the Little Caesars in the area, and the boss of all the Little Caesars would walk up to me and be like, "Hey, you're from this Little Caesars, right? What's going on? You guys need to do a lot better, because the sales are not adding up, and there's something going on there. I don't know what's happening, but we are not making the right sales."
Why would
because
they not
it's supposed
managers?
To be the manager who's going, but they sent me instead.
Why? Because you're the good one?
I don't fucking know, dude.
Why? You know what? You know what, Joel?
He's the motherfucker that dropped me off. The manager literally drove me there.
This story sounds like I could have read it off of Reddit. Like, this is like 100 upvotes on, like, FML or some junk.
I don't use Reddit.
This is an effing Reddit story.
To be fair, embezzlement is pretty common and easy to catch if you, like, know the right signs.
Yeah, he did embezzle, though.
I think that's a true for me.
I don't know. I don't know. Like, what are the chances of you just walking up and seeing him getting arrested live? You know?
Can happen.
It can happen, but so can a plane hitting me right now. I don't know. I feel like there's something fishy here. Joel, how many subreddits do you moderate?
I've never used Reddit in my life.
Okay, well, he's obviously
lying. That's a lie. I went to Reddit once for that r/titty drop when I was like 17.
What? You could have said r/place to draw some pixel Pokemon.
One of my friends told me about it. I was like, "Yo, for real?" And then I went to go check it out when I was like 17.
It took you till 17?
Well, I wasn't really interested in Reddit, because I was like, what the fuck is Reddit? I'm not going to sit there and read shit. I'm going to go do shit. I'm going
to
play games.
Why would you go to Reddit for Rule 34?
Well, I didn't know what Rule 34 was.
There's like a million other websites. Like, so it took you till 17 to see tits.
No, I didn't say that. It took me until 17 to see Reddit tits.
Yeah, I know. So you weren't looking at anything before Reddit.
You want me to talk about porn I was looking at before I was...
No, but you said Reddit was the first one.
No, I said that was the first Reddit that I ever saw.
Oh my god. Dude, you definitely read that story off of Reddit.
Listen, believe what you want, or don't believe it.
Filian still didn't see tits? Okay. Okay.
So,
how long did you work there before you got arrested?
Only for like a year and a half.
Okay. What did you do while you were there?
What do you mean? It's Little Caesars.
Yeah, pizza. Like, what do you do?
So basically, the Little Caesars I worked at was small, and you would
no, it's
take
average.
Out. I'm sure it has a nice personality, Filian. Basically, you take out the dough, you just fuck with the dough, put it through the machine to flatten it out. And then you would take it, you make the pizza, obviously, you put it in the oven. And everyone had a specified job, like someone would be, you're doing the dishes for a while, and then you're switching off once you're done with the dishes. You would be, like, making the pizza dough flat. You would be assembling the pizza and putting it in the oven. And if there was nobody else, the person who was assembling the pizza was also the one who would, like, slice the pizza once it came out of the oven, which was the worst job, because you'd have to sit next to the hot fucking oven in the shitty ass outfit, and it was all grungy because the flour dough made it sickeningly gross. By the way, can I mention that this motherfucker stole $20 from me too when I asked for a new uniform?
No,
so I just sit there and work in my nasty
ones.
Ass uniform.
Yeah.
Dang. Wait, so how big was
so
the
much
pizza?
Details.
How good was the pizza?
No, how large were the pizzas?
It's a Little Caesars. It's like 14 inches.
That's average.
Most pizza places have the same sizes.
It's average. Okay. Whatever.
Jill, how long was he embezzling before he was caught? Do you know?
I don't know, because he was there for a long time before me. And I only started hearing about the problems where we weren't having enough money like halfway through my job, because I was new and I was still learning the ropes. So obviously they wouldn't fucking talk to me about that or send me out to do the district shit.
Joel, why does... real question here. Why does embezzle sound like bedazzle?
Are you asking me about the English language?
It's got, like, pizzazz to it.
Yeah, I
know, don't
but
know.
I thought, like, if you embezzle something, that's when you put the rhinestones on, you know?
No.
What? Embezzling?
Is that not what it was? Like, what is this epic stealing money garbage?
Do you know what embezzlement means, Filian?
It's when you steal money, I think. That's Saruei, right? Back me up. Come on! The Mile High Club, remember?
Yeah, I think it was that.
Yeah!
Anyone else have any more questions, or are we good?
No, I'm good.
Fine, whatever, I'm good. Alright, next one! Saru!
Oi. One night, at a friend's house, I broke their favorite figurine when playing with it, and I pretended a ghost pushed it off the shelf.
That's really
you
cute.
You framed a ghost! You didn't even frame your friend, you just framed a ghost!
Ooh. How old were you for this?
Young.
If you're an adult and you're breaking somebody's anime figure.
Ooh, it's a ghost.
Ooh, a ghost did it. Ooh.
Yeah, so young like enough to like have this kind of excuse. It was, an anime figure.
Of what? What was the anime figure?
Riku from Final Fantasy X.
Who the frick is it? I thought Riku's from Sword Art Online. Not Sword Online, what the frick? Kingdom Hearts.
Sword Art Online, Riku.
I'm an NPC.
He dual-wielded the Keyblade.
Yeah, he dual Keyblades, bro.
The Keyblade dual-wielder, Riku.
What did you break? Or how did you break it?
So basically, it's like a figurine you can articulate, and I was playing with it as I was, lying
God,
in the bed,
articulate.
And I was like, making her pose and stuff, because I really liked the character. She was so pretty, and I just made her. Like, I don't know how I did it, but I just broke the arm. And I was like, oh my god. So I look on the side. My friend was sleeping, on the other bed. And I was like, oh, what am I going to do? I don't want her to freaking kill me. I broke, like, her favorite figurine. And I was like, putting it gently on the floor so I don't wake her up. And I was just decided to just go to bed like this. And when she woke up, she found it. And she asked what happened. And I'm like, oh, I don't know. Like, maybe a ghost, like...
So how did that feel?
Maybe it was just knocked off the shelf.
So did she believe you? What did the friend say?
She said nothing, but I'm sure she knew I lied.
What do you mean she said nothing? Did you tell her about the ghost thing?
Yeah, I told her about the ghost thing. But she said, alright, but she knew I broke it.
Okay, alright. How articulate was this figure? Was it like bulky or was it thin?
Like an action figure, kind of?
Yeah, was
like,
it
yeah,
an
you
action
can,
figure
you can
or was
move,
it opposing
the wrist,
like art figure?
You can reach the wrist and the elbow and the shoulders and knees and like the feet.
Kind of like a Figma.
Figma
what?
Is
it, Figma again? Figma. Yeah, like a Figma. Yeah, like a Figma.
Sorry, how did it feel when you broke it?
Huh?
Did you feel strong?
Did you feel good when you broke
No, I felt extremely bad.
Did you feel happy about yourself for breaking it?
Yeah. Did you like seeing the live train from its eyes?
No.
Okay.
Was it something that could be fixed? Last name Dahmer? Did it just pop off, or could you?
No, it's something that could be fixed. Mm. Needed glue.
Did you say I just popped off when you broke it?
No.
Okay. What I said. Sinder
said that.
Yo, her arm popped off.
Okay, so why were you awake after your friend was asleep, and why were you touching her toys?
Maybe because I really like her figurine, and so I really wanted to have the same, but I didn't hide it, so I was playing with it.
Aww.
And what was the character? Riku from Final Fantasy? Riku.
Yeah, 10.
Hmm. Okay.
Mm.
So, Dabs.
Sorry,
it's
wait.
Believable, but also...
Did you say a ghost pushed off the shelf, or did you say, I don't know how it fell over? Like, how did you tell her? How did you actually tell her?
I think at that time, I said, I don't know what happened. And then later on, I said, it might be maybe a ghost. I don't know. That's really weird, man.
That's really weird, man.
Oh, no! I think a ghost might have killed that person with 17 knife wounds. Like
a ghost also trapped me inside of a revolving door.
Oh, no. Help step ghost.
And
I'm
let
stuck.
Me inside of a... And let me inside of the concert.
Yeah, the ghost. The Holy Spirit told me where to go. It was divine interventions. Yeah, it was crazy, bro. I didn't expect it.
And she reacted just with nothing? Like, she wasn't freaking out or anything?
Yeah, for some reason, she wasn't, like, reacting that much about it. But I think she don't wanted to scream at me or murder me or something like that. She was remarkably
calm. Did
she
not care that much about the figure?
I guess maybe she didn't care. Yeah, I don't know. But for sure, like, later on, she gave me the broken figurine for my birthday.
Oh my god, you made you keep it!
Mm.
Well, it's still broken.
It was fixed with some glue, but she bought like a new one for herself. And
so
I got the broken
knew.
One.
She knew! She
That's
knew!
Pretty brutal.
When I got it for my birthday, I was like,
wait,
oh god.
You might as well woke up with a horse head in your bed.
Hold on, is she French?
No, she's effing Polish.
Yeah, no, she was Russian, man.
Wait, what? Was she?
No!
Where is she going? Oh. Right. okay, I see. Were you still friends with her afterwards?
Oh, yeah.
You break your friendship over a fucking broken anime figure? Is that important to you, Filian?
Well, I mean, she lied about it. She didn't come clean, you know? Like, I frame my friend. Doesn't mean we're still friends anymore, you know?
What about when you...
So...
I think it's because, like, she's older than me, like, of 1 or 2 years, and that's why she maybe didn't got upset, because she saw me like a little sister.
Mm. Okay, that's cute, though.
Dang.
Okay, alright.
I can't be mad, bro. Alright.
It's pretty hard to break those posable figures, though.
Yeah, I have
Unless
no
it's
idea!
An arc figure. Those
you're
ones
so
are
cute! Oh no. You cute aggressive to death?
Me to my Twitch chat.
What? Alright. Alright, we good here?
Yeah.
Alright, last one.
Yeah.
Bam! That's me. I ran 5 miles straight up with a broken foot.
No way.
It. You don't have the pain tolerance. I refuse to believe this.
How did you break your foot?
How did I break my foot? So I was on the cross country team in high school. There's this phenomenon where if you run too much on your foot, you can cause something called a stress fracture, which is essentially a break, but it comes not from breaking your foot from like blap, but from just pounding on it so much that it eventually snaps.
Oh, I have a question. So how's your feet today?
Wait, too many questions. What's going on?
How's your foot doing now?
What?
How's your foot doing now?
My foot is great. I can look, it's right here. It was this right foot. It
is. How long ago was it?
How long ago? This was high school.
You didn't feel any pain when running on it for 5 miles?
Oh, I absolutely felt pain. It's not saying I didn't. So
why'd you run 5 miles on it?
It was a race. Why? It was a race.
You chose to do a race on a broken foot?
I did not choose to do a race on a broken foot. I didn't know my foot was broken. I thought my foot was just sore. I kept running, and then halfway through the race, I was limping, but I was still running.
Did you win?
What?
Did you win?
Did I win? No.
Fuck no.
Filian never loses. But no, I finished the entire race with a broken foot, and I said, dang, my foot sure does hurt. I should get an x-rayed. When I got an x-rayed, it was broken.
I don't know, man.
Goddamn, how?
How big was the fracture?
How big was it? It was pretty small. It was like a bunch of like spider web fractures, you know? Like nothing crazy. It wasn't like my foot was splitting in half.
Yeah. I don't know, man. That would hurt fucking real bad. And to run on it for 5 miles? A mile's a long run.
Yeah.
A mile's not a long run. You need to get in shape.
We literally have a 7-minute run for a mile.
For the average,
For the average human being, 7 minutes
yeah,
for a mile.
Yeah, running for 7 minutes
that
is a
you
joke.
You ran for like 40 minutes.
Yeah, and I would do it again.
She on a fracture. No.
Yes.
And falls daily. I believe it.
I don't believe it.
It wasn't like my foot bone was like splitting in half. My foot was deformed and twisted like an effing twinkie.
Whenever.
Yeah, yeah, it's yeah. Like there's some tiny little fractures running through the bone where it's like, you know?
That's really specific.
It's not like you can feel like my bone creaking in on itself, you know?
But 5 miles though!
Yeah, 5 whole miles. It wasn't a normal cross-country race, which are like-
If it was like a mile, I'd believe it, but 5 is kind
of
fucking-
5 whole miles.
No way.
It was a race outside of cross-country on a Sunday morning. It was like a race in where I lived.
40 minutes, that would be way too much, man. Unless Filian's trying to say she's built different, but nah.
How fast were you running?
How fast was I running? I don't remember the exact pace, but it wasn't as fast as I normally do. So it was probably close to like 730 miles or something like that.
Was it the ghost that broke your foot?
Yeah, it was the ghost of Christmas past. Yeah, it was effing Saruei from the future.
Did Saruei wake up and you woke up and Saruei was
yeah,
Saruei
was
like,
playing with my foot and she snapped
foot.
It. Oh, ghost took kidney.
Woo! Oh, no.
Take into consideration.
Whenever,
you know, I guess physically taxing being a full body 3D streamer can be. I can see you having the stamina for
but this
that,
is that's the, this is now and that's then. So
yeah,
I don't know.
But,
okay,
what
how about
that
I, how about I give you guys another piece of information? I swapped out my previous story for this story. You know what the previous story was?
What?
I completed a marathon.
Oh.
Do with that information
was that a
as
true
you
one?
Will.
Was completing a marathon true?
I don't know, but it was what
you're
I swapped out.
You're just adding more lies.
That is supporting information you might want to take into account.
They are called stress fractures, Phil.
Have you ran a marathon?
I had them in both my insteps my senior year of high school.
I can't hear anything, so I'm just defining what I just
said
out loud.
I still played soccer anyway.
Wait, what was it?
Have you ran a marathon before?
I'm gonna say yes for the story, yes.
Yes.
Not that you completed it, but if you participated in one.
No, I completed it. That's what it was. I completed
it. Yeah, but I'm just like asking, like, if you have been in one.
Yeah, I've been in one before. Absolutely.
Oh, okay.
That's definitely
how good's your pain tolerance, Filian?
Way better than you'd think.
But don't you do, like, flips all the time and then just lay down on the ground?
Yeah, well, I mean, yeah, if you fall over, you're on the ground.
That's the comedic effect, Joel.
That does that is true. That's a good point.
I don't sit there
it
and moan like a family guy character.
There.
Like, it's not like that.
I don't know how strong Filian is.
I think she's capable of this.
Firepower.
Stronger than she looks.
Okay.
Yo, wait, what are you saying about me?
That you shouldn't underestimate.
That was Sinder,
somebody.
Not me.
Never underestimate the power of the Scouts Code. That's from Teemo. Alright.
Alright, I have my answer.
Okay.
Me too.
Alright! Alright, we're good?
Yeah.
Alright! Pachirum! End of the third round. Here it is! We're gonna start off
the
with the
finale.
Votes. Alright! Well, not yet. So, Sinder says, I flashed my panties to a live audience. Yes or no if you believe her. Boys.
Yay!
Yes.
YN,
I'm
chat.
I'm gonna type in. Here? Yeah, YNs. Here's, what is it? Cinder 3.
Yeah.
Alright. You know what, Cinder? I'm gonna say 3, because I know that at least one of your stories has to be true. But let me tell you, if you didn't tell me the skunk story and the two big guys barreling through your house, I would not believe this story at all.
There could be two truths, remember.
Yeah, I know, but there's no way. All right. Okay, I think she's an effing serial wire. All right, next up we have Joel3. He says, I watched my boss get arrested. Joel3. All right. I do not believe you actually watched your boss get arrested. I think your boss got arrested. I don't think you were there.
It was a very specific story, though.
It was. Oh, yeah. However, there could be a lot of truth, and then he changes the, you know, the end result. You know what I'm saying?
Sex.
Okay.
Okay. Where? With on who? An airplane?
Run, Cinder's mom, run!
Everyone was just really quiet. No. Ah!
I don't believe him. I'm saying no right now. Alright, are we all good here? What are we thinking, guys? You all believe him?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right. I believe me.
Joel would never lie to me.
Okay. Alright. Then, in that case, we have... Saruei! She said, I said a ghost broke my friend's toy. Yeah, this one's so sus.
I think no. I think Saruei's one truth was getting stuck at the revolving door.
I believe it. And I'm gonna say why. It's because when I was younger, I accidentally broke my at a friend's house. I knocked over a vase and it smashed. And they threatened to blackmail me unless I got in the trunk of their car. Oh, this is all true.
What?
Yes, wait, yes, what? And I did. So then I didn't get in trouble for knocking over the vase. Yeah, I had some good friends. Okay. So I would have done anything to cover up the fact that I broke the vase, including getting in the trunk of a car. So saying, oh, it was a ghost, that makes sense to me. Yeah, I got trunked. Alright, who has everyone voted? Oh yeah, they have.
Yeah.
Cinder, mm-hmm. What do you think?
I want to believe that, especially because the friend gave it to her, like, the friend fucking knew.
Yeah. Just like the clog toilet. Okay.
And what you last... trying to say about the clog?
The clogian. Alright. The last story is, I ran 5 miles on a broken foot. Let me put Filian 3 in here.
Filian. This one's hard for me. I think it's possible, but I don't think it is.
Okay.
I think it's possible. I just don't think the pain would have, like,
the pain
40
train.
Minutes on I in pain.
So. Mm.
Uh-huh. Dang, this is a bad
trick. I think Filian could, like, run a marathon Sweet. Easily. I think Filian's fit. I just don't think the pain would have been, like, I think it would have been too much. 40 minutes on it is insane.
Okay. What do you think, Sinder?
I think you could. I think you're a tough cookie.
Wow. Dang, what do you think, Saruei?
Yes, I'm same. I think you're capable of running 5 miles with a broken foot.
So you're telling me the token male said no and all the women said yes?
I think she can run a marathon easily. I just
you're
don't
so
think the
racist.
Pain would
so
be there.
It's not like she broke her ankle, like the bones
yeah,
snapped.
Like a
I've never had a broken foot before. I'm assuming it's going to be hurt like fucking hell.
And no, I didn't hurt that bad.
And
you should have specified
stress...
that.
If it's a stress
you should have asked.
That shit happens, you know, like, over time, too. Like,
yeah,
it's
yeah.
It's progressively worse.
Yeah.
A fracture I've never is a been break hurt in my life.
Yes. Yeah.
I got a tiny fracture, so I know what it is. So that's why I can believe his story.
Hey! Alright, plug champers! Alright,
save the medical knowledge chat.
Are
I don't
you guys
have
ready?
It.
You guys ready? Alright, let me come over here.
Ready!
Let's see all the truths!
Here. Intense game show music. No. Or does it? Yeah, whatever. Alright. Perfect. Here. Alright, let me get this junk going. Alright. Perfect. Alright! So now, snackers, we have gone through all 12 stories. It is time to figure out what story was true, what story was false, who the liars among us are. How sus is Joel, really? So we're gonna find out.
Level.
Remember, you're watching positively. What the frick? We're watching Possibly Possible. Frick. Whatever, I don't know what I named the show. Anyway, the cops are almost here. So we'll be just fine. It's time to click for results! Bam! Wait, what? Bam! Wait, what?
Is the audio good there, chat?
Hello? Oh, there it
Hello?
Is! Alright. So, Sinder, here's what we're gonna do. Alright, no one can check the Discord chat except for me and Sinder, of course, okay? That's how we're gonna do this, okay? So, Sinder, you told us a story about two guys... who broke into my house. Alright, can you please reiterate the story one more time?
Yes, so the complete story...
Uh-huh.
There was this white van that pulled into my driveway.
A white van? Okay. Unmarked white van. Good story.
Big buff guys get out.
Yeah.
My door has this big glass window on it so I could see them through my kitchen while I was in the kitchen. I went to hide behind the island in my kitchen. They opened the door, walked right in, went to my parents' bedroom, took their mattress, their bed, and walked out with it.
Got it. Okay. And so now I'm gonna come over here. One sec. Here. Too loud, too loud, too loud. That's better. Alright! Well, bam. Okay. Oh. So, Sinder, now you will type in the Discord for just me and you.
Yes.
Yeses and noes. Alright, so let me know with the Y or an N which one it was.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
Alright, and the answer was... The story was... Absolutely true!
Yeah!
Okay, interesting.
Oh, yeah.
Sinder.
High five, Saru.
What was going on with the story? You said that you thought they broke into your house. Is that what it was?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So, it turns out that my parents were ordering a new mattress. And I didn't know that, and they didn't tell me. Mm-hmm. And I had actually told my parents. I went out to dinner with them last night. And I was telling them about the stories I'd be telling on the stream today. And my dad was like, oh, we didn't tell you? I didn't realize you were home alone when that was scheduled to happen. He was like, oh, shit.
He found out he traumatized his child.
Yeah, and I was literally, because I was on the back side of the kitchen island, so the drawer with the knives was on the other side, so I would have had to sneak around to grab a knife to defend myself.
Dang.
But luckily,
oh my god.
My parents' bedroom was in the other direction.
Interesting. Okay.
If she stabbed one of them, that would have been so bad.
That would have been really funny. You would have actually been Eren Jaeger and Mikasa. Alright. Yeah, Home Alone Simulator. Okay.
My Home Alone arc, yeah.
So, I think we already have the records, but let's go through and see who voted for what. Saruei, did you think the story was true or not?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Alright, 1 point to Saruei then. Guys, keep track of your own scores, okay? Alright, Joel, did you believe it was true?
Yeah, of course.
Alright, and so did I. Say goodbye. That is... 3 points for each one of us, or 1 point for each of us. All right, so we all have 1 point now across the board. Sinder has zero because it's not her turn yet. All right, here it is. Sinder, it is time for the second story. Tell us again what it was.
So there was a bunch of skunks running around my yard. Their mother, I'm assuming, the adult skunk, was dead in a hole. So I rounded up all the babies with my dad. We got sprayed and we were very smelly. And my dad built them an enclosure to keep them in. And we fed them eggs until they were old enough to go out on their own.
Fake!
Alright.
I think it's fake.
It's time for the answer. Alright, Sinder, feel free to type it right now.
Yes.
Alright, what? Hey!
Yes,
that is also
correct. Yes, isn't the answer.
She typed
it. I typed it.
It was a true story, according to Sinder.
Which
means that every single one of us just got that wrong, because we all said it was fake.
All right, Filian, I am sending a photo.
What
I actually found a photo of the skunk.
No way.
Enclosure that we made. I got the color of the wire wrong, but it was
her
like,
whole
like
family
plastic.
Agreed
oh,
to
not
race.
The color.
Oh, that's
holy freak, she actually did it.
Oh my god. Oh,
yeah, she got effing receipts, baby.
That's okay, they are kind of cute. I'm not gonna lie.
Cute. They're kind of cute.
They were all huddled up together, and then we go on the other side and put the food over there and feed them.
Dang, she had effing
seen
receipts.
People have skunks as
so
pets.
The full story there was that, my yard was kind of split into like the front yard and backyard by this fence, and it was one of those thick plastic fences, so there had to be a hole dug in order to keep the posts in the ground.
Yep.
And we were redoing the fence, so it was all dug up and there was still a hole where the post was, and the mother skunk had fallen inside the hole that the post
you
was.
You killed her!
I didn't!
You're a murderer!
You killed Bambi's mom!
She just happened to fall in there, and then she wasn't moving, and we saw some of the babies moving in there.
My knife just happened to stab the mover.
Oh no, that's so unlucky.
And they had this little den on the side of like a shed, So we ended up looking around for the rest of the babies that were hiding and running around where their mother was and stuff. So we took them in. And then after...
So that it all makes sense now. You adopted them because you killed them and you felt guilty.
No, I didn't kill
them! Wow. You have been shorting your cat. Wait, what do you call it? What do you call it when you like when you capture someone and they fall in love with you? Stop! You stalk-homed a bunch of skunks!
Yandere?
You stalk-homed a bunch of skunks.
However, we really cared about the animals, so my parents and I ended up volunteering at a wildlife shelter, and we took care of animals and fed them and stuff like that. So
that's really cute.
She killed a skunk. We did do that together. I did it again! Uh-huh.
I really like the part where she died. Okay.
Stop! Oh my god!
Stop.
All right.
Can't believe Filian likes dead animals.
No, okay, listen, okay. You're beating a dead horse right now. Alright, so
she brought it up again!
Oh, whoa! Alright, okay, so we all have 1 point now because we all said no to that story. Sinder, the epic story with the circle and the hole and the babies all around it, that was really sus. And I'm figuring out why it's sus now. It's because you killed her.
It all makes sense!
It all makes sense now.
It was an accident.
Okay, well, that's why you were so effing dodgy about that one. I get it.
That's gonna hold up an Animal Crossing court.
Yeah, you're effing going to jail, kid. Resetti's gonna reset your life. All right.
No!
Yep. All right, so we're gonna go on to the third sin story. Please recapitulate it.
So I was on stage at a cosplay competition.
Yep.
I was wearing brand new heels, tripped and fell when I was turning around and flashed my panties to a live audience.
So this is fake, right?
Well, that we're gonna find out. All right.
That was the most emotion she had when telling the story, so I thought it was real.
Wait, you're right. Yeah, by default, that means the story wasn't real, because the other two were.
Yeah.
Damn, oh dude. My god!
She got
I am a professional level cosplayer. However, I've never fallen on stage before, nor have I flashed my
pants. That's why I told you! I told you guys the epic safety shorts would have been there! But you
I
know
was
what?
Fucking
you know
sus what? Sinder, that the cosplay judges were like
you're,
that.
No, you were oh my say, god, I love Sinder's story. You believed your hook line
and
sinker.
That one time I had this like sexy armor build that I made, and I had this like flap of fabric that was supposed to cover my crotch, so I just wore panties because I was like, oh, I'll be covered just fine. But it was too small when I was trying it on at the convention, and so I kind of low-key had my panties out. Like just the sides.
Okay.
Always wear shorts, everybody.
But I hadn't flashed them on stage.
I see.
It was a different outfit too, by the way.
Cool.
Okay.
Frick. Okay, you know what? You know, Sinder, I would have said no if I hadn't said yes to the other story, which means I had to say no here or whatever.
Yeah.
I said no twice. God frick.
And I'm a really bad liar, so I feel like I had to be sus with the first two stories because then I'd be extra sus if I was lying.
She was pretending to be sus.
Yeah.
She's the imposter.
Brain.
Wait, you should have pretended to be sus. It must be true. What the frick?
Right. Well, I knew that I was a bad liar, so I'm just like. Yeah, there were skunks and,
oh my god.
Can't believe it.
Okay.
Her brain expanded for this.
Okay. Alright, so we all have 1 point now at this point, which means Sinder basically destroyed us all. Holy frick. Alright, well, we're gonna move on.
Did she get a point for fooling us?
No, but it's up who gets 9 points, you know? Alright,
okay.
So we're gonna go ahead and move on to the next round. Ching, Joel.
Hello.
It is time for you to capitulate your stories, and let's go through them all.
All right, so I flirted with my best friend's mom.
Oh,
basically,
man.
The idea is that for around a year and a half, every time I would go over to my friend's house, I would
What?
Why did you cut out?
You
cut out.
Every time I go to my friend's house, I would
Why did my thing cut out?
Hello?
Can you hear me now?
It got redacted. Yeah. Filtered.
So,
damn,
okay.
You
basically,
No.
Basically, for a year and a half, I would go over to my friend's house and basically say and compliment her that she was very pretty and very nice.
You harassed your friend's mother. All right.
Well, I sexually harassed.
So, for this story, We all said yes, which means if it's false, it would be very interesting to note. All right.
Oh, yeah.
Joel, is it true or not? Type it in there.
It is.
Don't say it.
False.
Oh, my frick, dude.
You're all wrong. I would never do that.
You make it sound like it's so fucking unreasonable.
I never went to my friend's house because I liked my house too much.
Good dog. I knew your story didn't make sense. You said you harassed this friend's mother for 2 years in front of him. There's just no way you do that when you're 17. No way, dude.
I did compliment her occasionally, but it was all the time, and it was not flirting. I was always saying that she was very nice.
We're getting bodied, dude. Holy frick.
And look at him now.
And now Cinder's mom is. I'm Cinder's mom's Oshi, apparently.
Okay. Alright, so what's the score right now? I'll start with Filian. I have 1 point. Joel, how many do you have right now?
I have 1 point.
Saruei?
I have 1 point.
Cinder?
I don't have any!
God damn, this is a low score.
Wait. But we got right to I watch my boss get arrested. It's. Yeah?
Well, we don't know yet. We don't know.
We don't know. Okay.
Yeah, how would we know? All right. I tried to eat my phone is up next, Joel. Tell us about it again.
So, basically what happened was in middle school or high school, somewhere around with my Windows phone, I set up an alarm to wake me up in the morning every day. But because this is the first week and I was incredibly tired throughout this week, the alarm went off because I set it up for every day on a non-school day and it woke me up super early in the morning. And I was incredibly sleep deprived and groggy. So my fucking stupid ass, youngin brain was like, let me bite down on the phone because if I close my mouth, the noise will stop. And it did. And the noise stopped and I didn't hear it until the next morning when I felt the fucking little bits of like plasticky glass in my mouth. But the phone wasn't that badly broken. It was just a little bit cracked.
All right, okay. Joel, is this story true or not? What type your letter?
This story is true.
What?
That's bullshit.
No way. You bit yourself.
My phone when I was a kid.
No way.
And I woke up the next morning and I was like, what the fuck is wrong with me? Is what I said the next morning. I was like, what the fuck happened? How tired was I?
Holy frick. Did anyone even believe this story?
No, I didn't.
No one believed this dunk, did we?
He's really a moron.
Oh, he's actually... Wait, what the frick?
He's actually a moron.
No, no one said yes.
I've told this on stream before.
Oh my frick, God. We all got fake effing story, dude. Okay, so
and
now
the
it's
final
just,
one.
It's still 1-1-0. Jesus Christ, this is a low-scoring game. Alright, what is it?
I watched my boss get arrested.
Yay!
My boss is a piece of shit, and he embezzled money from a little...
Yay!
I've told this story a lot. Now you, and I've said it on stream a lot of times, but
yes,
there's one thing that is different with this story.
Whenever, Filian
actually called it out. I was not there to see him get arrested. This story is false.
Let's go!
He got arrested when I wasn't there.
The world's great detective right here.
I never saw it happen.
Wait, one part? That seems like bullshit.
No. He literally said, I watched my boss get arrested. He literally did not watch his boss get arrested.
But that's wordplay, though.
No, it's not. He said, did I see his boss get arrested or not? He didn't.
It's the truth and the lie, not the treat, like, two lie and one truth, no?
No, it literally, read what it says. He tried to eat his phone, that is true. He did not flirt with his best friend's mom. He did not watch his boss get arrested.
Oh.
I've told this story on stream, so I thought I would trip up people. But every time I tell the story, I always say, I go into the store the next day, and I was told that my boss got arrested.
Yep. You're allowed to base a story on truth. It doesn't need to be completely made up. Like, every good lie has truth to it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And so as long
people
as
people in the chat are saying I never heard him say that he saw him.
All right. All right. Well, that's
Filian
pretty
got a
much
point.
It. Okay. So wait, what's the score right now? We're done with Joel's answer, so we're halfway through the points. I currently have two.
You're in the lead.
That's it. I'm leading two. What?
But the rules were like two truth and a lie.
We can do either or,
sorry. Sorry, I explained it like seven times.
Ah, fuck.
She said,
it could be two lies and a truth or two truths and a lie.
Oh my god!
Okay.
All right. I love Saruei. I love Saruei.
Okay. Alright. As it is, it can be two or one either way. Alright. Alright, let's go on to Saruei yourself.
I didn't think Filian got it. I've told the story to Sinder before.
Wait, Sinder, no? You still got it wrong. Oh, yeah,
you never told me that shit!
I did. It was on our date night.
Drama! Drama! Drama!
No way!
I don't care about you! Oh!
Yeah! Oh, fuck!
Sorry,
her mom likes me more than her!
Man, how do you feel?
This is fucked up. Her parents like me more than she does.
Oh, frick, Lama. Oh. Alright, it is time for the for Saruei to go ahead. Saruei, could you recapitulate your story?
Yeah, so I step by stage to get an autograph, and I succeed by doing this because a friend invited me over by giving me a VIP badge he found in the backstage.
Yep. Alright, and Saruei, please type your answer in the group chat. Yes or no if it's true.
Okay.
Alright. Oh, wait, did you type? Wait, I gotta scroll down.
I did.
Oh, I see, okay. Alright. The answer is... It is true!
Fuck!
Yeah. Yes! What the frick? This one was actually true?
Yeah! Oh. Like, I actually met Frank from Carpenter Brute, and this is actually a selfie with me and Frank.
Whoa, you're not actually gonna post it, are you?
You can show this one.
He does look like he would say a dad joke.
Oh, you... Oh, wow. Saruei turned into a purple blob. That's crazy.
I had to sense on myself.
Uh-huh. No, she's actually a purple blob in real life. Yo, that's kind of sick. He's got a Metallica shirt on. Okay.
Not even his own band's merch.
She's so pretty, true.
Oh my god.
Holy frick, she brought receipts too. That's crazy. That's crazy. Okay, so let me see. Did anyone say that was true?
Sinder did.
Sinder, you're gonna win. No way.
You got your first point, Sinder.
This is my first point. What do you fucking mean?
Okay.
Wait, you're in the lead. You have two. Everyone else has one.
All right. Okay, so Sinder, wait, I have two. Everyone else has one right now.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, but this is the last round for me to actually get points. All right, Saruei, story number two.
Okay, so I got stuck in a revolving door with my best friend when we wanted to go shopping. Mm-hmm. And we got a security who come over to help us to get out.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Alright, well, this one sounded pretty real to me, but Saruei, please type your answer.
I just realized Saruei thought this is two truths.
No way.
Oh, fuck.
It was not a true story.
No!
We're getting destroyed!
Fuck!
Is it because you stole a story from Shy Lily?
Huh?
Where did the story come from? How did you come up with it?
Oh, I just asked ChatGPT.
You asked ChatGPT?
You motherfucker!
I was like, what can I come up with? You know, I don't go out. So I was like, man, what can I say? So I ChatGPT.
AI overlords are better at lying. Dude, just use ChatGPT to win your court case. No way. Huh? No way.
Oh god, does that mean the last one is no? No.
Saruei. Huh? Over the last story now. Did anyone get the one right? We all got the revolving door one wrong, right?
Yeah.
We are so bad.
It's just believable. Like, it's so believable that she'd get stuck.
Uh-huh. And then the last one, I said it goes broke my friend's toy when I was playing with it at night when she was asleep. And I just put it on the ground. And when she woke up and asked what happened, I just said, like, I don't know. That's weird, man. I think maybe it's a ghost or something.
All right. Saruei, do you believe it? Type your answer. Oh my frick.
This is fucked up. This is fucked up.
It was real. It was real. Filian,
why are you saying, oh my god, you got the point?
I think I said yes to every single one of Saruei. No, I said no to the first one. Okay.
Yeah.
Wait, so you
Filian
guys didn't believe
her? Has 3 points now.
Okay, 3 points.
Sinder has 2. Saruei and me have 1.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, but I can't get any more points right now. So if Sinder gets 2, I lose.
Yeah.
All right, Sinder, how good do you really think you are?
I don't know.
Running around leaving scars.
Oh my god.
Chat, what is your score out of 9 so far? If you guys are keeping track. Approximately how many did you guys get right so far?
How well are you guys doing? Yeah.
The effing bingo card.
Has anyone gotten everything right?
I'm 9. Okay, yeah, okay. Yeah, okay, bro.
There's no way somebody got all of them right, dude. I only got 2, bro. All right, well, my chat is the worst scores.
All right, my chat type 20, so I don't think they have brains. Let me see what we got going on here. All right, my story. My first story was I framed my friend for clogging a toilet. Basically, while she was upstairs, I was downstairs. I got her mother to come and unclog the toilet under the pretense that her daughter was too embarrassed, and I had to come tell her to unclog the toilet on her daughter's behalf. Yes. That is the story! As for whether or not it's true, I will play the sound effect. 1, 2, 3. It was not true.
It was not true.
I also just checked our answers. We answered the same for the first 2 questions, and the last one, I'm the only one who answered.
Okay.
This
I'm worried that you would be possible.
This story is not true because I sat there and I heavily contemplated it for about 10 minutes before I didn't do it.
Oh my god!
So, I went and told the mother myself on my own behalf. And I was very embarrassed.
It was so believable, but you know what? I'm glad that you took responsibility.
I did not frame my friend.
You still clogged the toilet.
Okay, everyone thinks I framed my friend. Yeah, I did, okay. Yes.
But it's better that she took responsibility for having a massive dump in her
friend's
house.
Okay, yes, I took responsibility. Okay, alright, next one. I once asked the plane pilot for a mile high badge. Pretty much what happened was I wanted to get a badge from the pilot because they give them away to kids, and I didn't know what it was called, and this term was in my mind called the Mile High Club. So I said, hey man, can I get the Mile High badge? Much to the chagrin of my parents and the pilot. Alright. And the answer for one that this was true is... Dun 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 dun! It was false. It was not a true story.
We all said no. Yes.
You all got a point.
Which means it's null because we all got a point.
Correct. Yes. So this was indeed, whatever the frick. So that means what's the score right now?
I have 3.
Me and Saruei have Saruei has 3. I have 2. No.
Right, I have 2.
Me and Saruei have 2.
Cinder has
3.
2 still.
Wait, no, Cinder got it right.
This one.
Yeah. Okay, Cinder's 3. No way! Okay, so Cinder's tied with me. If she gets the next one right, she wins. And then otherwise, you have to just continue to type. Okay, Cinder, what did you say for this one? Yes or no? The third one. I ran 5 miles on a broken foot. Did you believe me?
I think you did.
Okay. Saruei, what did you believe?
I said no.
Okay, yeah. You said no.
I said no.
Saruei said yeah. Oh yeah, right. This is where the guy said no. Okay, yeah.
Fuck! Right.
So pretty much, we're gonna go ahead and get this junk started. Dun dun dun! Did I actually run 5 miles on a broken foot? And for the win! Dun dun dun! Yes, I did!
No,
I ran 5 miles on a broken foot!
You're crazy!
The first one was just so believable!
Wow!
Damn.
Yes! So
oh
I did
God.
Indeed run 5 miles on a broken foot. Pretty much what happened was I didn't know my foot was broken and I was on a race. And it was like some race outside of cross country, it was 5 miles. So I woke up and I ran. I was like, my foot really hurts. About 2 miles in, I was practically limping, but I'm a good runner, so I put more weight on my left foot. Finished the entire race, only to find out that my foot was broken after I got it x-rayed.
Okay.
It did not hurt that bad. It did not hurt that bad.
How much pain is a broken foot? Is it not that bad if you were able to run on it? Am I crazy for thinking that it would be super painful?
My foot felt like a brick. Not like super painful, but like really stiff and sore.
Like I said, I've never fractured anything, so I don't know how this works.
Yep. So pretty much that's what happened. I actually did run on it, and then I was not allowed to run for a few months, and I was really upset. But that means by turn of events, Cinder, you have bump it a bum 4 points, which means that you are today's god dang winner. Woo!
Congrats, Cinder!
Yep, so
thank
there it
you.
Is. Cinder, you have absolutely won today's show. Congratulations.
How much you won?
Yeah, what's my prize?
I will be PayPaling you a dead skunk mother.
No!
Yes.
Absolutely fucked up.
Absolutely, yes. You talk about daughter like this. What?
Phil, the only one who got my shit right. Neither of you got any of my things right. Philly knows me better than that. What the
fuck? Hey! Let's go! Holy freak. That was actually really fun. I'm glad we figured out, you know.
Those are good stories, dude.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Pretty fucking fun.
I try to think of stuff that I haven't mentioned on stream before, which is really difficult.
Me too. That was actually really
mentioning
difficult.
The stuff that I talked about on stream fucked people up more, so.
True. Like, I only brought one story that I mentioned on stream before, which is the one true one. I was like, okay, well, I'm gonna make up two ones so I have more stories for stream, you know?
Fuck, dude, that's impressive. 5 miles. Jesus Christ.
Yep. So, anyway, that's pretty much a wrap on all this junk. A pretty short couple hours, we in and out. But yeah. Sinder, Saruei, other person, thank you guys.
He's doing this again.
Joel, thank you guys so much for coming out. We all scored below 50s. We are getting F's, and we are not passing the second grade or collecting $200. So, yeah. But that being said, it was really fun hanging out with you guys. So, thank you guys so much for...
Thank you for inviting me.
Yeah. All right. It was fun. It's always creative being on here.
It was fun.
Everyone's so creative.
Oh, my God. But that is pretty much a wrap on my end. So, thank you guys so much for hanging out. And yeah, you're free to go. Class is dismissed. Go on, you know, go eat some paint or whatever people do in their free time.
Sure.
But yeah, it was really fun having you guys on.
Bye. Take care, Filian. Thank you. Yep.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Wait, bye and bye are the same words. That's crazy. All right. Holy moly. Let me go and hide all this junk, too. All right, chat. What do you guys think about that junk? What do you guys think about it? It was a different idea, one I'm not particularly used to, but I figured it'd be fun to try it out and see how it is, you know? So, yeah. Alright! It was fun, it was neat, heck yeah. Alright, snackers, I think that'll be it for me for today. I think we're gonna wrap it up here. So, what this is gonna look like in the future is, tomorrow is, you laugh, you lose. I'm gonna have fun with that junk, it's gonna be great. It's just gonna be me. The Astolfo costume's not in yet, so I will not be wearing it tomorrow. But probably for the next few laugh views, we'll have it in. Alright, so yeah. That being said, if you're new here, please feel free to drop a follow. I try to do weird stuff like this, have fun with it. And, yeah. I really try to put a lot of work into the streams. This one was a decent amount of work to put together, so I hope you guys enjoyed. Also, on Monday, we're gonna be doing Horror Night in VR chat. Not VR chat, well, in VR chat, but just Horror Night in general. So... I'm gonna play some Beat Saber on Monday, then we're gonna do some Horror Night gameplay. Okay, on the 23rd, the 24th, we are having the 2-year stream anniversary. Well, we're gonna do like nominations for your favorite Filian clips of all time, basically. So what we're gonna do is, after the stream in my Discord, discord.gg/Filian, it's in the description of the stream, you can find a button. Make sure to join that jungle, okay? We're gonna create a channel called award nominations or like category nominations for the Phillies, you know, for the anniversary stream. So you can write like, oh, you know, the cringiest Filian clip, the most watched Filian clip, the whatever, worst flashbang clip, whatever the free guys want, you can put that junk in that mother chucka, okay? So yeah, and then on Saturday, we're gonna open up a channel for actually like nominating the clips themselves, okay? So that being said, that's pretty much all I got for you guys. It was fun hanging out. It was great having Sinder and Joel and Saruei on stream. Always great hanging out with them. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I will see you guys tomorrow. But this anniversary stream is gonna be like on Wednesday, I think, the 23rd. But yeah, all right. Yeah, we can raid Joel. I don't know if he's still gonna be streaming. We'll just raid him anyway. If he's gonna stop streaming, we'll call it a day. But yeah, thank you guys so much. Hope you guys enjoyed. Wow, I'm tired. All right, let me go press the raid button. Raid Shadow Legends. Joel. Alright, who knows how long he's gonna keep streaming for, but I'll raid him. Alright, snackers, that'll be pretty much it for me for today. I will see all of you freaks later. Have a fun time with him, okay? And I have a good night. Yeah! Okay. Adios! Ahuevos! He's ending, get wrecked. Alright, snackers, go tell Mai for me. Tell him he's a cuck. No, don't tell him that. I don't know. Alright! You know, I don't even know what to tell him. Say, like, Filian's mom raid or something. Don't say that. Okay. All right, I'm gonna see you guys later. Have a good night. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Brrr. Pushing, pushing. Bye. Goodbye.
Sure. I don't know who Sinder is inviting, but we'll see how that goes. I was gonna end the stream, but that's cool. I'll take the raid. I'll fucking steal the viewers and make my raid look bigger by raiding somebody else. I'll take it. Why not? Why not? Filian's mom's raid. Hello? Is this Filian's mother? Am I getting raided by Filian's mom? Is that what's happening? Giga Chads? Giga Chads? Giga Chads in the chat? Giga Chads in the chat? Filian's mother is here? Hello? You don't have to keep feeding her fruit snacks. You can give her, like, healthy food. I get it. It must be tough raising a child like that. But, you know, eventually it's going to turn into a bad habit if all she eats is fruit snacks. Give her some real fruit. She's not available at the moment, so wait your turn. Damn! Fuck! I forgot her chat roasts her more than me. Fuck me, dude. God damn. Maybe I should be nicer to her. I didn't realize that her chat was going to hit her. Filian said you're a cuck. All right, never mind. I don't need to be nice to her. Fuck Filian. She can take the L. Chat, keep being mean to her. You guys got this. Well, I'll dogpile in. Let me join in with you guys. We'll be a part of it together.